Hey y'all, welcome back to another special program, and this one is a biggie for the Herverse. It is time for a new nation, time for another our next adventure. After saying goodbye to Fontaine, the Fontaine arc is over, and now we're heading off to our next region, which is Natlan, which is 5.0. So it's time, y'all, it is time to react to the special program, seeing what's gonna be coming up, new characters. Obviously, we've seen the character's been drip marketed already, so it's not new. But obviously, seeing when who gonna be first phase, second phase, and all that, and any other new characters are gonna be showing, and also two other, seeing the environment of Natlan and all, so it's gonna be something. And also too, y'all know since it's 5.0, the devs will be talking, and I gotta be reading and trying to look at the pretty things on the screen, so it's gonna be. Be something, and I'll do it's a this is a long live stream, it seemed to be. So yeah, there's gonna be a long video. And actually for once doing this live while the live stream is live, I'm doing it because usually I wait until, because they usually start the live stream around like five, not five, seven something, my around my time, Eastern Standard, 7 in the morning. But this time they did it real early, around like 12 a.m. till like 11 my time. So I'm like, oh, they doing early. Yeah, so we're gonna get into it now, and y'all obviously get my reactions, hear my 2 cents. You already know, I've seen so many special program from me, y'all know, share my thoughts and all that and my excitement. So yeah, let's get into it. Oh, that's loud, I'm sorry. Obviously, we want to skip this.
Of all kinds, it's the ladies, gentlemen, and travelers of all kinds. It's the voice of the fabulous fox.
Oh, it's
Guy
oh the fo
Mikos, the one,
4th anniversary
the
as well. I forgot.
only
Oh, thank you so much. You're too kind. Now, for almost 4 years, we've explored every corner of Tivat, uncovering stories of all kinds. To celebrate our 4th year, we've prepared a little game show where you're the contestant. Now, I know what you're thinking. Retina, is this just an excuse for you and your friends to geek out about Genshin Impact lore? And to that, I say, you think I need an excuse? Anyway, here's the first question.
Let me see.
According to A, what could have been used to bribe Yaimiko? A, new books. B, shampoo to keep her tail and ears fluffy. C, rare fabrics and silk. D, fried tofu.
Fried tofu, D. I'm guessing.
The answer is D.
I know my
okay,
girl.
If you got that one right, pat yourself on the back.
Yes.
There'll be other chances. Now, I need to get Josie ready for the next round, but I'll see you soon. Good luck, travelers!
Hey, Josie Montana McCoy here, voice of Kaya. Ready for round two. Retina sounded kind of serious in that intro, huh? Well, between you and me, I don't want to be the one to disappoint her. Question: what does the Court of Fontaine legally consider Paimon to be?
Oh, I
A,
know this one.
A personal assistant? B, an endangered species? C, a balloon? D, a cultural delicacy.
Let's see. If you play the Fontaine arc, you should know this.
C, a balloon. And I have heard that for the very steep price of one sticky honey roast, Paimon will join your hometown parade. I don't know, it's what I've heard.
Hey everyone, Paul Castro Jr. here, voice of Fremenae. And it's my privilege to welcome you to this latest round of Tivat Trivia. Speaking of welcomes, what warm welcome did the House of the Hearth give to the Traveler and Paimon?
Ooh.
A, cosplaying as Paimon, imitation is the highest form of flattery. B, presenting them with a captured hilly churl rogue. C, a crash course on espionage and poison brewing. D, a traditional Snezhnayan dance.
I'm gonna go with C. I don't know. C? Well, I don't know this one.
The correct answer is C.
Okay, yeah. I was like, that
I don't
one
know
makes the
about you
most
guys, but my
sense.
personal poison is kombucha, and I've never actually brewed my own. I need to try one day, though. All right, that's all for this round. And remember, never store your poisons in an old soda bottle. Use a neutral container and label them clearly.
A process of elimination.
Kim Yen, voice of Gaming here. Who's up for a little true or false?
Coming.
True or false? When Kuching got her vision, her first instinct was to test her newfound power.
Ooh, I don't know this one. This was like 1.0 days. I don't know. I wasn't here before 1.0.
Kuching actually took offense to the idea of needing a vision, so she tried to get rid of it. First by burning it, then smashing it with a minecart, and finally, dropping it from the Jade Chamber's roof. I mean, that's crazy. Huh?
Oh, yeah.
What's that? Oh, Hoyoverse wants me to remind you to practice safety and responsibility when it comes to dropping objects from great heights. Especially if said object shoots lightning. You know, if I had an electrovision, I'd probably, like, use it to make pancakes or something. Because then you wouldn't need to use, like, the stove, and it could just be like, oh, pancakes! Sorry, that's all for now, but there's more to come.
I had to do some deep diving for this question. You get it?
Fremine, diving.
Okay, true or false? Everyone in Fontaine knows the Melusines, but few know their origin as the children of the Hydro Dragon. False!
Oh,
Melusines are the children of the great beast Aelinas.
Yes!
Though children is a bit of a stretch. They were.
Okay, that one had me right. I was like, wait. I was like, no. I know, what's his name? Let me forget my precious man name. Nuvi. I know he like, see, those are his children, the Melusines. They are. Those are his legit babies. Now, I was like, not technically, because I did the, world quest for this. I'm like, I know the Melusines are like, they're children of another thing. So I'm just like, that like stumped at me. I was like, he sees them as his children, but it's not technically from him.
They were born from an explosion inside its corpse centuries ago.
Yeah,
now,
corpse.
Me personally, I've never seen a corpse explosion birth, but I'm sure that's quite the sight to see. Yeah? Who would have thought such cuteness would come from something so dark? But then again, the same could be said about our boy Fremenay.
Yeah.
Guess who's back?
Fontaine is all dark.
This time, I've got a really good one. My treat. Yenfei may be one of Liyue's greatest legal minds, but what job would she pursue if the world no longer needed her counsel? A. Rapper.
No.
B. Liyue's resident lamplighter. C. Spa owner. D. Fish tamer.
I remember she said this. Well, I don't know.
A. Rapper. Hey. My name is Yenfei. I practice law in the city of Liyue. That doesn't really rhyme. Yeah, I wouldn't pursue being a rapper. Anyway,
I had a feeling
it
was rapper, but I was like, really? It's been minutes since I did her thing. So I was like, yeah.
True or false? Kaya is one of the first three natives of Mondstadt to join the Traveler's Quest. False. Kaya isn't actually a native to Mondstadt.
Yeah.
He was born in Conria, but was abandoned in Mondstadt as a child. He was later adopted by Diluc's dad, of all people.
Yeah.
All right, that last question was a little bit tricky, but it's all about keeping you on your toes.
Yeah, I was like, yeah, cause I was like, he's from Conria. We soon find that out when he had, I think, his second hangout, if I'm correct.
Doesn't really rhyme. Yeah,
That is one of the.
But yeah, because I won't trigger it. It triggered me. I was like, wait, because he's from Conria. It was closer to me.
Adopted by Diluc's dad, of all people. All right, that last question was a little bit tricky, but it's all about keeping you on your toes.
It only makes sense they'd save the best for last, and I've got a very special question in mind. Hope you brushed up on your history, folks.
Oh, goodness, no.
True or false? One of Liyue's protectors killed a monster with nothing but her waistline.
False.
True. During the Archon War, a monster tried to swallow Ganyu, only for her waist to catch in its throat. The poor beast ended up choking to death, a fact that embarrasses Ganyu to this day. Honestly, I think Ganyu is perfect just the way she is.
Didn't know that.
Life. You know,
I probably forgot.
We're really lucky that monster didn't succeed, because Ganyu is a pretty great friend, and we're lucky to have her on the team.
Her waistline did all that.
And that's the last round for this year. If you made it this far, it's time for the roundup. If you got three questions or less, don't sweat it. This was just a game after all. Besides, this just means there's plenty for you to discover. If you got 4 to 7 questions, then you're pretty well traveled. Just remember, there's lots to see when you go off the beaten path.
I didn't keep count.
If you got more, then you're a real lore expert. I'm sure you've got plenty of theories about where the story's headed. maybe some headcanons too. But don't rest on your laurels just yet. We've got plenty of surprises waiting just beyond the horizon. Thank you so much for playing, and I hope you had fun. Now, whether you are an OG or you're brand new to the game, I just want to say thank you for being here. We couldn't do this without you. It is so much fun to experience this game through your eyes, and I cannot wait to see where we go next.
Aw, she's not fat. Probably was it like a little monster, probably? Who knows? But yeah, I forgot this special program was the anniversary as well, too. So that probably was like equally as long as well, since it got the anniversary stuff in it. But yeah, 4 years old. Genshin's gonna be this year. 4 years old. Not the Flappy Birds reference. Sure. Oh wait, do I got the subtitles on? All right, we're gonna get into the, we're into the trailer already?
We've arrived at the final phase. The winner of this match will take the final spot.
Slightly tan with that hair. Cute.
For a long time contender and first time finalist.
From this point forward.
Oh, this is the trailer for 5.1, 5.0.
No longer applies. Anything can happen here. There's something in the depths of this place that feels familiar, yet also foreign.
The pilgrimage is not merely a trial to determine the strongest among us, but also a stage upon which to showcase your individual growth.
The purpose of the pilgrimage is not only to select strong warriors, but also to collect contending fire from the battles. Natlan is only safe from the invasion of the Abyss, while the sacred flame burns eternally.
Look at the new characters, they're looking cool. Very fun to play with.
Guess I'll have to wait until the next pilgrimage.
It's so pretty.
I'm still not sure why Arwaiup chose me of all people.
It took the combined efforts of the then Pyro Archon and heroes from every tribe to finally repel the Abyss.
Look at the dinosaur wars!
The effects of the invasion lingered for hundreds of years.
So pretty, oh my goodness.
Little by little.
Our current Archon achieved an overwhelming victory.
Current Archon.
The result was obvious from the beginning.
Archon.
I really want to win this time and become a true warrior.
But through our long history of fighting the Abyss, we've realized things aren't quite so simple. The Abyss has invaded the Night Kingdom, and has the capacity to read the memories of this land at any given moment.
Going there, the Night Kingdom?
Only those who triumph over the Abyss earn the right to be revived. Defeat not only means death, but also the destruction of your ancient name, preventing it from ever being inherited again.
You heard something from here, didn't you?
Kinich, what is the meaning of this?
Kinich.
Only one way to awaken you all from your willful blindness. More sacrifices must be made.
You'll die if you try to make your way forward. Why don't you just give up?
You want to know why I won't give up?
I should have died 5 years ago.
Take me as your next sacrifice.
Sacrifice.
Natlan is on the verge of destruction. It's very possible our nation has less than a year before total devastation.
Once your ancient name disappears, there's no coming back.
No! Why can't I find him? Why?
Every great display of power comes at a price.
Oh, where are we running from?
That is the tragedy of your short lives. You understand nothing of all-encompassing power.
We shall unite the tribes and save Natlan from its impending doom.
What use is the Gnosis in your hands?
I don't know what you mean.
Ooh!
But it sounds like this is about more than the Tsaritsa.
Your plan has Pyro Archon right there.
And now it falls to
if
me
you play more.
To create new rules for Natlan.
Oh, that's
people like us.
Capitano.
Blades do the talking.
Ooh, her hair. Ooh, that was epic. Capitano and Pyro Archon. Oh. That was amazing. So much to suck up, but wow.
Ooh.
But yeah, we gotta rescue another nation from being doing something again. Nothing new. Nothing new. We always gotta rescue some nation.
这次远程前瞻啊，有些特殊任务需要我亲自完成，我去找项目同学问一下。Joey。
He got a little bubby on his back. Feedback from travelers.
看来大家对娜娜还是有很多期待和疑问嘛。那我们也不能辜负大家的期待啊！让我去现场听听项目的同学怎么说。准备怎么样啊？
挺好的，准备领原石。好，那各位旅行们，大家好，欢迎来到原神5.0前瞻特别节目，我是你们老朋友大伟哥。那么今天呢，我们又请到了我们的项目组老朋友啊，战斗设计师鸡哥，我们的 IP 负责人小罗号。
Hello，
大家好，我是大家的老朋友鸡哥。那这一次来到5.0的前瞻节目呢，也是要跟大家去分享一下我们在新的版本，也就是纳塔这片区域上的游戏内容的一些设计思路和设计理念。大家好，我是你们的小，我是你们的老朋友小罗号。那个，很荣幸还是由我来在这个1.1度的这个大版本啊，就是和大家分享一些我们纳塔的。
世界观和角色相关的一些信息和情报。
欢迎我们的小朋友老罗浩和鸡哥来到我们的前瞻特别节目啊！哎，那么我们今天啊的这个前瞻节目跟以往有点不一样啊，肯定要给大家一些小小的挑战。啊，挑战？我们的挑战吗？
啊，
对的，
那个发源石吗？<笑>哎。
那大家别紧张啊！哎，之前我们不是做过一轮那个问卷调查吗？
没错。
大家其实对我们那个纳塔其实都是非常非常感兴趣的。那么今天啊，我们也是专门把这些问题挑出来啊，请你们两位现场来给大家那个解答。
啊，现场答吗？
就没有稿子吗？
不要紧张，
对吧
？No script，
大家都非常紧张，
script。那么，要不先试试看？试试就试试呗。
好，那我们开始第一轮挑战啊。那我看一下，我们第一个问题啊，好像是比较特殊的。
问题还有特殊问题吗？
让我们来看 VCR。
在 4.0 版本的前瞻直播当中呢，项目组有提到过每年都会推出一个新的玩法，那这次就是新的大世界移动体系。那选择它作为原神纳塔版本新玩法的原因是什么呢？在制作的过程当中有解决什么技术上的难题吗？
我觉得这个人这么熟悉一点，因为刚好我也是战斗设计师，这部分刚好也是我的专业领域嘛。我先说一个比较大的概念啊，就是。 原神它其实是一个开放世界游戏，当然这个大家都知道，对吧？但在我们的理解里面，其实开放设计游戏它更关注的两条，一个是关于玩家交互行为本身，以及交互行为带来的反馈。对，那其实大家也都知道，就是在原神的过往的版本里面，其实我们一直有一个叫元素的概念。那元素这个概念本身呢，也是。 交互反馈的一种体现，就比如说我去拿火元素，打一下冰雾花，这冰雾花可能就变成一个可以采集的状态，对吧？那交互的反馈，在这么多的版本里面已经获得了非常充分的体现。对，那这次我们想换一个思路，我们想在交互的形式上去做一些花样。 尤其是其实玩家其实更关注我们的角色能做哪些事情，对，因为原本我们会发现在比如说1.6的版本，我们有一个新增的玩法叫浪船，对吧？然后在3.6版本我们做了一个叫花灵的这样的一个族群，那么他们有一位叫斯露莎的勇者，对吧？那他其实也会有一些独特的移动方式。那到了5.0，我们其实想做一个尝试，把这些东西。 全都呈现在角色自己的行为模式里。 对，那其实大家在 4.8 和 4.7 这两个版本前瞻的彩蛋里面也看。
Wait, and me and the Easter eggs of the version 4.7, 4.8 for the program, everyone has seen some clues. Yeah, because they like to see getting clues around the last patch. And did we see it? I ain't paid. Did we? Me. Darn it, I'm like, I think I did. Oh, the app lets you redeem codes with one click. Okay.
看到了一些端倪，就是包括我们展出的这三位角色，他们都会有各自不同的行动
方
式。
啊、哦，我理解了，就是说我们角色的这个移动能力是不是要得到空前的这个变化？
对，其实你看，就是之前我也看到过有旅行者在社区里面有说到，那这次我们是不是可以有一些飞檐走壁的
啊
这样的一些行为模式嘛？那大家也都在视频当中也有看到，我们确实是在做这样的尝试。
哎，我看到还有玩家问到啊，说那个前瞻彩蛋里面那个马达尼踩的那个滑板，它到底是个道具啊，还是个技能？
其实我觉得就是硬要说的话，它其实是算技能，但是我觉得呢，就像刚才我说的一样，其实这些新角色的行为模式是融入到它的方方面面的，就是它作为一个技能来说，可能有点狭隘吧。然后第二条其实是，如果把它作为道具的话呢，感觉有点。
他应该是伙伴才对，
对，应该是伙伴。
这个我感觉我已经感受到了啊。那么我们问完这个第一个问题，我感觉鸡哥还可以啊，鸡哥还可以，游刃有余啊。那我们再看看是不是要提过一点更难的问题啊？
还有更难的吗？
这个 ，How are we going to see like the movie? Like they're just going to show us what they're talking about, but without the way, I think.
又是一个彩蛋掉落
啊！
让我们来看第二段 VCR。
はい、皆さんこんにちは、マグロヘッドです。今回は原神チームにバージョン 5.0 に関する質問をしてみたいと思います。ナタ初報 PV で数種類のドラゴンが公開されましたが、あの力を借りて空を飛ぶことはできるんでしょうか。 PV の最後にね、飛んでいくドラゴンいましたけど、あんな感じで飛行してみたい
Caesar,
それと、ナタのキャラクターって独自の探索システムとかは持っているんでしょうか。よ
ければ
たっぷり教えてください。
也是一位我们的老朋友。
这一位其实我也看过，好像是叫
金枪鱼头。
对，金枪鱼头。对对对对。
他的凯亚系列攻略我很喜欢。
对，包括七人召唤他也特别喜欢凯亚。
啊，对对对，是。
OK， 那其实他刚才也有提到说，龙的探索机制是如何设计的？
对
啊，他提到说在我们PV 的末尾是有一个飞行的龙，这个其实稍微有点剧透啊，因为可能
透
Yeah, continue with the spoiler.
其实就是包括这条飞行的龙在内啊，纳塔所有的玩家看到的这种不同形态的龙，他们各自都会有一套独特的探索机制。那这个探索机制呢，和刚才这个问题里面我们提及的，包括纳塔的角色。他们之间也会有一些息息相关的设计点。大家肯定会有疑问说，之前在视频里看到说我们好像可以操作这些龙，进行探索。
对对对，
那到底是我们通过某种方式驯化了这条龙，还是说我们把自己放到这个龙的体内怎么样，对吧？那其实我想说的是，我们其实提供了一种类似附身的这样的一个机制。
附身。
对，可以让旅行者在纳塔的领域区域内，去通过。
Oh, this is so cute. Shows can use in willing. Yeah, that's what's called mechanic in that land. So yeah, this is what it is in willing. We can transform into the creatures. I'm gonna say antimoons.
过附身的这样一个
and use their abilities.
机制去获得这些龙的操作权。那不同的龙当然它也会精通不同的探索的一些本领。
Trying to back that up。
意思说到
后续，
而且我一查的时候，
那也是 ，right here。
获得这些龙的
，to gain control over the， black。Oh sad. What's sad? To gain control over them. Okay.
操作权。那不同的龙
，of course, different will master different exploration skills. Okay.
当然，他也会精通不同的探索的一些本领。
对对对，我感觉基哥的意思说到我们到纳塔之后啊，我们是可以
飞檐走壁，
对吧？
对，没错。那还是回归到刚才金枪鱼头提到的那个问题啊，就是我们会不会有飞行的可能？我只能说，大家可以敬请期待，纳塔后续的版本里面，我们给大家提供的。
please look forward to the content we provide in the future versions of NotLand. Really, you couldn't tell us because look forward to the next of the future updates of the NotLand. that's still a question mark. Can we still fly?
的内容
我感觉前面两个问题都是鸡哥，我一定要抽一个给小罗号，对吧？不能让小罗号闲着。好，我们在做问卷调查的时候，有超过30%的玩家提到我们整个娜塔的这个世界观，就是大家都想了解，比如说娜塔的这个设计这个灵感是从哪里来啊？包括说我们在娜塔里面非常重要，有很多龙嘛，包括觉得娜塔也是一个这种人龙共生的这么一个国家，所以想请小龙号跟我们讲讲在这个纳塔啊，我们这个人和龙之间到底是一个什么样的这个共生关系啊？
我们知道就是纳塔的部族当中啊，龙啊被纳塔视为自己的家族成员。
对 ，so cute, he's so adorable, my heart.
对，
说一个
，there's a big one.
能不能龙啊被纳塔人视为
？Let me read.
自己的家族成员。
People of Natland. Oh, that's so cute. They're like family. They're family members. My heart. Oh, such a cutie. Such a cutie right there.
对对，
说一个可能不是很恰当的比喻，有点像我们养猫猫狗狗一样，就是龙其实就
是
可能不是很恰当的比喻，有点像我们养。
What is that? What is that? Look at that face.
猫猫狗狗一样，
是They're like cat and dog, cats and dog.
就是龙，其实就是纳塔人的。
Their companions are people of Natland. Oh, okay, that is so. They're like, oh, that is so cute.
伙伴，
对，那我还是愿意养龙的。
有机会，但我也很想。他们在一起生活，在一起工作、战斗，彼此信任呢，也彼此照顾。
对，
虽然纳塔的人和龙伙伴之间可能没有办法直接用语言相通，但是长久的相处呢，也能够让他们能够弄懂彼此。的心思和一些就是习惯了。
对。
那么我们旅行者在拜访各个不同部族的时候呢，就可以发现纳塔人和龙伙伴相处的方式可能也会有些不一样。就比如说在我们应该第一个接触的部落回声之子中，稳重可靠的疾风龙伙伴呢，会帮助他们的部族成员挖掘宝石和矿物，或者呢在山洞当中去开辟通路。
哇，这个很有用，感觉很有用。
The little babies right here, y'all. The little babies found the big one. My heart. Ah.
在山洞当中去开辟通路。
哇，这个很有用，感觉很有用。
对，然后呢，它同时呢，它们的爪子和那个钻角呢，就很需要就是人类伙伴的照顾了。那这个地方我也就简单的先抛一抛，因为我们5.0会接触到这三个部族的龙伙伴，然后在之后的环节当中，我们会有专门的同学来给大家进行更详细的演绎。
对，
这里我就先小卖一个关子。
对，就接下来的环节，我们还会有更多相关信息的爆料给大家提供。
对对对对对，我听完小龙的介绍，感觉在这个纳塔啊，人和龙是一种非常和谐共生啊，而且是非常有爱的这样一种氛围啊。
That's neat that they have that harmonious relationship.
那么我们接下来看这个第三题。那第三题呢也是个特殊问题，我们来看 VCR。
我们看这次又是哪位大佬。
What's up guys, I'm Tuanto, and I'm here to ask some questions for the Genshin team regarding 5.0. Pyro's the spotlighted element for the new update, specifically for Natlan, and I'm curious, how does Pyro have a significance in Natlan? Will Natlan be more accessible for newer players in the game? Because I do know that a lot of newer players have difficulties and or struggle to get to the newer pieces of content that get added to the game. Honestly, it is insane that we are at Natlan now. I want to give you guys all my luck, because if I can't win the 50-50, I hope at the very least you can. And I hope you find your own true meaning on your own journey.In Genshin Impact.
这一位我也认识。
感谢他的这个提问啊。那接着他的提问呢，我就简单说一说，就是火之国。那火在纳塔呢，有着独一无二的实用的意义。除了我们普通的那种火之外，纳塔还存在着广泛存在的一种名为燃素的物质。那燃素呢，有着不同的形态，每一种呢都有很独特的妙用。这一点呢，我觉得旅行者一进纳塔探索，就能自己亲身体验到了。
那在纳塔其实大家可以把燃素认知为一种
Wait, Palo, what is that? Palo, wait, let me see how to say this show.
Phlogiston.
Phlogistons? Wait, what? That's how you say that?
Phlogiston.
Phlogiston. You saying that right, Google?
Phlogiston.
Phlogiston. That's what it's called. Phlogiston, okay.
纳塔独有的高阶的
It's an advanced form of pyro element unique to Natland. Okay.
能源
火元素的呈现形式啊，它有时候可能是能源，有的时候又可能作为一种战斗当中的策略资源。那当然，除了战斗方面的价值和探索方面价值以外呢，它本身也有很重要的精神层面的一些意义。
火就是纳塔的精神图腾嘛，
对，
就像我们纳塔的最核心的建筑物地标圣火竞技场，
没错，
里面有昂扬不灭的圣火，火就象征着纳塔人他们永不屈服的一种精神。然后纳塔历代有很多英雄和英杰，他们用自己的精神和力量将纳塔的火不断地向未来向新一代去传递，无论他们遇见了怎样的艰难和挑战，他们的火都不会熄灭。
我们一直知道那个纳塔被称为是这个战争的这个国度啊，那么其中这个战争的含义是什么呢？
之所以说纳塔是战争的国度，是因为纳塔在历史上曾经面临过无数场危机。那么为了保护自己的家园，我们之前提到纳塔的人民还有纳塔的龙，他们一起并力同心抵御着各种侵害纳塔的势力。那么在一场又一场这样的战斗中涌现出了无数的英雄，那他们在这种战斗和战争中留下的英勇事迹呢，就被记录下来，在黑曜石上刻写成为古名。古名也是我们纳塔的一个比较核心的一个人文概念，然后以此将英雄们的事迹和精神传承下去。那么一代又一代的纳塔人呢，在古名的引导下不断的成长，不断的去战斗，和过去那些他们历史上的英雄们一样，用自己的力量支撑着纳塔在一个巨大的威胁之下屹立不倒。那么到了如今呢，六大部族之间依然会彼此竞争，在圣火竞技场所举办的大赛中比拼各项的能力，从而选拔出最为强大的战士，继续向着战场去进发。
对，所以就是说纳塔的这个战争
sort of meaning of war. No, it's not war that. Oh yeah. So this meaning of war in Natland is not the war that we understand.
并不是我们理解的那个战争，是而是
It's more of a competition.
Sure. 竞技，对吧？
其实它
是 ，it's both come，
它是既包含了竞技，也包含了可能大家广，
and the kind of combat that is wildly
广泛认知里面的战斗。Okay. 但是呢，通过竞技选拔出来英雄们，他们要和什么样的势力去进行对抗？他们又如何看待就是他们身处的战争？那就请玩家朋友们直接在。5.0 即将开始的主线剧情中去切身体验了，
几乎有这个五成的这个问卷啊，都提到了这个火神啊，相信那个旅行者们啊都很好奇，说火神是有什么样的性格？那旅行者呢，在纳塔又会跟火神一同经历怎样的故事？
火神嘛，我们简单来说，他就是纳塔人的领袖，就是纳塔所有战士里面的最强人、最强者。
She's so pretty and gorgeous. So yeah, if I'm understanding this right, so the war, the meaning of the war is not actually like a war currently going on in that land. So it's not what we think it is. It's just it's a competition of some sorts and like the crisis that's going on and they have to protect that land, if I'm getting that correct. So that's what that meaning is. So not like a war against each other, I think.
那火神率领着纳塔战士们迎接了无数的战争，也夺得了无数场胜利。无论面对怎样的敌人，火神的火焰从来没有暗淡过半分。就是对于纳塔人来说啊，还有纳塔的龙，只要跟随着火神，他们就可以战胜任何胆敢侵犯纳塔的敌人。他就像是一轮永不落下的太阳，在他的照耀之下，所有的迷茫和不安都会被驱除。那么当我们的旅行者啊，到我们的纳塔和火神马威卡相遇的时候，再和他一起踏入战场，想必也会一定会体会到马维卡的热情，感受到他的光芒和温度。那至于他的性格，我觉得大家很快就能够体会到他所拥有的那种和他的力量相匹配的那种。
Her queen-like confidence matches her power, as it should, because we felt her energy through the teaser when they teased it. I was like, I know she, we gonna love her, we gonna love her, we gonna love her, we gonna eat her up, a queen, a baddie. We already can see it. So I'm just like, we gonna be eating her up, hopefully.I'm just saying, we don't know, because they can do a whole 360 with her real quick. So I'm like, but I'm like, we're gonna love her. That's what I got from it. Yeah.
王者一样的那种自信啊。
对对，我印象特别深刻，因为我看我们娜塔前段短片的时候啊，看到当火神。
I love they bringing up the teaser too. Said that, yeah, she obviously she stands out with her hair, her whole appearance. Like she's just giving ethereal baddie.
嗯，马尔卡走出来之后，充满了这个自信啊。
对对对。
前面聊了这么多啊，我看我们还有。
Oh, I just thought about something. I wonder the confidence is what she obviously exerts, but inside it's a whole nother different story. Her internally. I wonder, I was like, oh no, I'm just like guessing, theorizing in my head. I'm like, is it, she's just putting on a front? Or is she obviously, she's actually like that? Well, she probably like, is actually like that, but inside like she's like worried about something, or I said, I don't know. But I'm just like a little kid. I'm like, like something's like deeply going on that obviously she can't tell or say or something like that, or she don't know what to do. I'm guessing.
两个特别有意思的问题啊，那也请两位来一起来看看。
안녕하세요쌤입니다오늘은원신팀에게 5.0 버전과관련된몇가지질문을드릴건데요우선나타는발자취영상을보면부활과관련된뭔가있는것으로보이는데혹시원신세계안에이미죽은누군가가부활하다는뜻은아니겠죠아그리고우인다집중한카피타노두꺼운톡으로쓰고있는데설마나타의무더운날씨에기절해버리는건아닐까싶습니다
这两个特别有意思的问题看看谁来回答
那这也是剧情上的问题吧我来说一说就是说到特定角色复活这一点啊我可能说得远一些就是战争的国度嘛它必然会伴随着牺牲那死亡从来都无法被轻易逆转但是呢在纳塔唯独在纳塔就是我们英雄们的火焰不太会轻易的熄灭就我们足迹PV里面说到戴英说过一句谜语嘛就败者成为战火的余烬而胜者重燃
对
那在纳塔牺牲是无法阻拦英雄们奋战的脚步的他们是有机会去继续战斗直到那一场战争彻底的终结那至于是怎样的一个重燃的这个机制不要卖一个关子因为这个就是我们可能纳塔的剧情里面一个很核心体验的一个部分
就是那大哥你知道就每次到这种时候我其实是憋得最难受的那一个、就是、
那你说说队长吧
行 OK 就是那队长其实在纳塔的整个主线剧情当中也扮演了一个非常重要的角色对那刚才小罗浩所说到的重燃包括战争这些概念某种意义上也是队长来到这片土地的原因对对那刚才至于刚才那个比较
不能说太多了
至于说刚才那个奇妙的问题说他会不会在纳塔中暑那我可能再剧透一下就是可能由于某种原因我觉得他不太可能会中暑
哦我感觉我已经 get 到一些信息了啊那个既然两位都说到了这个火神与队长啊那么我们纳塔的其他新角色是不是也该登场了
那是
哦对哦我们讲了这么半天好像还没有讲到
角色
对不过在此之前啊我们先看一段短片
Some information we just learnedTread on the sand. Our first character we get to see. We love a Hydro cutie. So cute.And our Geo cutie. She's just riding around, just living her best life. Mr. Kinnitch himself. Well, I don't know if I'm saying his name right. Kinnitch? Kinnitch? the Dendro man. And so, with a little companion. Two, well, 8-bit companion. Codes! Y'all can get them while they're hot on the press. Obviously, if you're watching this video, I don't know, these to be good throughout Friday, if y'all watching it. Well, obviously, if you're watching this on a different day, then obviously the codes aren't working. Oh, the 17. Oh yeah, y'all should be good. Back that up. There we go. But no, this art looks so epic. Just like a lot gonna be going on.
接下来我们就把现场交给项目组的同学们了，有两位啊为大家介绍5.0版本的新角色和新剧情，我呢就提前下班了。啊，这样的吗？那好，接下来请说。那我俩来呗。哦，那我换个姿势啊，我换个姿势。那既然聊到旅行者们最关心的角色，那还是鸡哥你作为战斗设计师，你先来。OK，好，那刚才我们聊到的时候也说到呢，在纳塔的6个部族当中，他们有一些身怀绝技的各个部族的勇士，那么这3位角色也是来自于不同的3个部族的勇士。哎，那么在纳塔的魔神任务第一幕。
Obviously, yo, y'all know, we already got the Archon quest. We back at it again with Archon quests. Act, what chapter is this? Y'all, my numerum room, is that chapter five? Chapter five and numerum numerals. Yes, okay, good. So yeah, chapter five, Natland, act one. Oh, we got act two as well. So we got act one and act two in 5.0. So, okay. Yeah, I know them streams gonna be long. Obviously, no, I'm definitely gonna have to break up the streams depending on how, like, if they get lengthy. But, ooh.
荣花与炎日之途中，旅行者就可以和这3位勇士一同参与到在圣火竞技场举行的归火盛宴巡礼，见证这场对纳塔最高荣誉的角逐。不过啊，说到勇士这个称呼啊。 在这3位勇士当中，可能有一位小姑娘了，她可能不太敢，这么认可自己。
OK， 我知道你在说哪一位了，那就是在之前的节目当中。
She gotta say her name. Ooh, shoot. Do 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 do.
Kachina.
Her name is Kachina. She's so cute. Geo.
跟我们有见面过的那一位小姑娘叫卡奇娜，对吧？卡奇娜是货真价实的回声之子的古名持有者，而她的古名乌沙伯帝。虽然她自己并不明白为什么会被赐予这个伟大的名字，因为有很多古代的英杰和先烈，他们都曾经持有这个名字，但是她认为她既然得到了这个殊荣，她就有义务参与这个在圣火竞技场举行的归火盛宴巡礼。虽然她一直。 屡战屡败，但是屡败屡战，所以他真的很坚持。
Yeah, never give up spirit.
在我看来，就是这样一位小姑娘，她每次都能坚持参加，那我觉得应该也是一个很了不起的人。那么她的这个载具，我们把它叫做冲天转转。
Wait, her vehicle, which is called Turbo Tweakly? Tweak? Tweakly? Tweak? Twiggly? Wait, not me forgetting the R.
Twirly.
Twirly. I was close. Turbo Twirly. I was close. Damn it. But Google, as I say, is my best friend. My bestie. She be helping me with the words.
也是大家看见的那个像钻头一样的载具，我觉得也一定能帮他在比赛中提供一定的助力
吧。Amor underscore is now following.
Amor, thank you for the unfollow, appreciate it. Amor, I think Amor. Yeah, Amor.Thank you for the follow.
那首先卡西亚就像大家看到的那样，他其实是一位岩元素深之眼的使用者，那么他也会通过自己的技能来召唤出刚才我们一直有聊到的那个
冲天转转、
冲天转转，就是这样一个像钻头一样的载具，那么他也有不同的方式。
Oh, now we can see how she's being used. Also, she uses different ways to
是跟冲天转转之间进行交互，比如说他可以直接骑乘到冲天转转上，然后通过这种方式来提供快速。
And use it for fast moving and to climb walls. Okay.
移动呀，攀爬墙面呀，以及可以在这种情况下去冲击地面来攻击敌人。那它同样也可以把冲天转转当做一个单独的战斗单位进行召唤，那么它也会独立的。
Oh, it can do it on its own. Okay, Gucci. She can get out and kick butt. So individually.Deal geo damage.
产生岩元素伤害，而它的元素爆发会划定一个。
Her ult will create an aura similar to the say.
施工场地一样的领域，那在这个领域里面呢，其实冲天转转也会获得一些强化的能力。
And will also gain some enhanced abilities. Okay. So the ult gives her enhanced abilities.
除了这些战斗的技巧以外，那卡奇娜当然她作为部族的勇士，也有一些当地人的从容。
Oh, yes, thank goodness. She's obviously a local, so she's going to be helping us get materials around on the mini map.
那么她熟悉大塔的当地区域，也就是说她可以在玩家探索过程中，在旅行者的小地图上显示纳塔区域特产的位置。
哦，特产雷达。
没错，而且她在去和纳塔的一部分采集物交互的时候呢，还会去恢复。
Not her harvesting stuff from, I don't know if it's strictly in that land. When she's harvesting stuff, it replenishes her stamina. Roll that back.
她在去和纳塔的一部分采集物交互。
Yeah. And with interacting with some of the Natland harvestables. Yeah, so yeah, it's just Natland. Yeah, figured.
或者时候呢，还会去。
She gets more stamina. With the whole party. Okay.
恢复全队的体力，
这也算是四星角色里面他就特别能够帮助我们去进行大世界探索的一个好帮手了。
旅行者们呢，在纳塔的魔神任务也就
So let me see. Progress through the Archon Quest Chapter 5 blah, 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 and invite. Okay, so we are getting her for free because some people were wondering, will we get a character, a 4-star character? Obviously, we ain't gonna get a 5-star character for free. Not in this game. But we will be getting a 4-star character from Notland for free when we do the Archon Quest, Chapter 5, Act 1. So after completing Act 1, she'll be invited to your party. So that's cool. We love that. So we get to play her.
就是荣花与炎日之徒这样一个魔神任务当中，开始后不久就会遇到卡西娜，
啊，
那随后他就会很自然的
加入到
主角的冒险队伍当中了。那我们说了这么多关于卡西娜的传闻啊，那接下来我们要介绍的
，And now we got our next cutie. We can use free. I like, yeah, she's free. I wish it was baby, but.It's oh yeah, speaking of that, they haven't done yet a child boy before, because they always do child girls, obviously. Chi-Chi, what's her name? My adorable princess. What's her name? Oh, her name is slipping me, y'all. Damn. It's Alice's daughter. She is slipping me. Oh yeah, Nahida. But not Nahida. Is there somebody else? What's her name? Klee. There it is, Klee. But yeah, but they haven't done, and also to what's her name? I'm about to say Sucrose, not Sucrose. Sayu. Yeah, they always do girl children characters, but they never have done a boy child character before. Yeah, I'm waiting to see that. When they gonna give us one of them? A little baby daddy, be a little cute, a little adorable. We ain't get that one yet. No, Mika's not a child. Well, I'm talking about in the small form of like how Kachina was. She's like she's like small in stature. Mika, he's like obviously a little. He got height to him a little bit. But let me see how to say her name. That's an I. Mulani. Again, she's so cute, and of course, I think she is the 5-star. Pretty name, yeah. She is so cute. Her idols, right? Well, we're seeing right now. Love it.
妮她酷爱各类水上运动，比如说游泳、跳水、冲浪，还有沙滩排球。 但比起自己玩的开心，他更享受和大家一起度过美妙的时光。无论是他作为水上用品商店的店主呢，还是他作为一个新生代的向导当中的一个佼佼者呀，马拉尼他都非常热心于和他人推荐一段充满乐趣和惊喜的旅程。那么在不足记闻流泉之众当中呢
，Of course we got her story quest to do. We love a good story quest. Learn more about the character.
旅行者就有机会和马拉尼一起踏上一场探寻传说。
Wait, her eyes, if you don't look too fast, her eyes kind of look like strawberries a little bit. I like just got that in my head. It's just like, it looked like strawberries. Obviously she has like her pupil looks like fishes, which is cute. But if you like look real fast, it like looks like she got strawberries for her eyes, the inside.
中啊，神秘岛屿的一个旅程，那相信已经横跨五国的旅行者一定不会错过这样的冒险和挑战。
因为他也是流泉之众的勇士，那么他在战斗当中也会有一些独特的作战方式。首先大家也可以看到，马拉尼是一位使用水元素的Catalyst
Hydro character.
对，他是一位法系角色，那会搭乘一个叫。So
I think that's her E. If you use it, it can go. She obviously on water, and I think she can do it on land. Probably gonna show it. She's Sharky surfboard. Surfboard. You got your surfboard glitch, but it's tied to Mulani.
沙沙冲浪板的这样的一个水上用品来提升自己在地面和水面上的这样一个行动能力。那马拉尼本身是一个攻击节奏可能不那么快的角色，但是因为他很灵活，他可以利用自己的身法为自己接下来发动的这。
I'm trying to read and look at things, shall we? It is not a very fast paced attacker. Oh, she's not fast. Damn. They say she's gonna be a little slow fighting. But she's very agile. Okay, so she makes up for
that.她可以利用自己的身法为自己接下来发动的这次攻击去积攒一些优势。所以她在移动当中呢，这个沙沙冲浪板可以标记并且撕咬敌人。这个撕咬可能本身并没有产生一些
The biting itself might not have a strong effect. Why have a stronger fit?
很强的效果，但是在之后马拉尼主动发起的攻击当中，这些行为会给他提供非常大的注意。
Okay, I was like, can she mark more than one enemy?
你主动发起的攻击当中，这些行为会给他提供非常大的注意啊，就积累资源，对，没错，从而得到更大的优势。对，那它的元素爆发呢，也会发射一个巨大的沙沙导弹啊，迸射出一个非常绚丽的涂鸦。就大家也看到，娜塔有很多涂鸦性质的这样的一些表现，对吧？让也会。
I'm trying to read the thing.
基本上嘛，水上用为。 提升机节奏可能不那么快的角色，但是因为它很灵活，都是这个四角可能也会发射一个巨大的沙沙导弹啊，迸射出一个非常绚丽的涂鸦。就大家也看到纳塔有很多涂鸦性质的这样的一些表现，对吧？让敌人能够冲。就大家也看到。
You see the Natlan has a lot of graffiti style elements, which I like that. That's very new. They added that graffiti like, because I noticed when she did she was doing her normal attack.
产生一些很强的效果，但是在之后嘛，可能所以他身法攻击节奏可能不那么快的角色。
Right here,
因为他
it leaves like a little paint splatter a little bit.
很灵。
Yeah, so I like that they added that style with Natlan here.
他
对
之后嘛，
积累自
也会大家也看到纳塔有很多涂鸦性质的这样的一些表现，对吧？让敌人能够充分感受到来自流泉之众的勇士的这样一种水上运动的精神。然后刚才说到了马拉尼的一些作战能力啊，那其实除了在战斗当中在敌人之间进行穿梭以外呢，这个沙沙冲浪板的这个状态，它还可以帮助马拉尼在一些特殊的地方自由的穿梭。
Special areas,
而且他还拥有一套和卡奇娜一样。
And she also too, just like Kachina.She helps with material gathering. Yes.
这样的探索的能力，也就是他也可以在小地图当中去显示纳塔区域特展的位置。
哇，那不愧是我们流泉之中最好的向导呀！他的移动方式又很特别，然后又很灵活，而且还能帮助我们去探索大世界。
除此之外，他还有一些别的能力，也就是说他在纳塔这些存在燃素，刚才我们有提到燃素这个概念啊，就在燃素机制的区域里面和一部分的采集物进行交互呢，他还可以去恢复整个队伍的燃素值。
那三位勇士中的最后一位，则是来自我们玄牧人。
I gotta say his name again. Wait, let me see. Kinnitch. Yes, I said it on the first try. Kinnitch. But now we get our Dendro boy, who's giving very much Xiao vibes. But yeah, we got him. He looking good as well.
人不足的年轻猎龙人，他名字叫基尼奇。
基尼奇
啊，他看起来虽然有些沉默寡言，但身手非常的干净利落。多年的野外生活的经验赋予他制服各种野兽和恶龙的方法。同时，他也是少数能在归火盛宴巡礼中多次取胜的人。
跟基尼奇这样的人一样啊，就玄牧人这个部落里有不少的部落成员都喜欢挑战
极限
对，然后他们的实力肯定也不同凡响。那他们这么强大，是不是有
But the secret to be
有什么独家秘诀？比如说，我注意到基尼奇好像不是孤军作战，对他身边其实有一个很奇怪的。算是生物吗？有个很奇怪的龙伙伴。
Yeah, what we call him? I just call him little 8-bit dragon of his.
对，那个这个伙伴是为他在战斗中会提供不小的助力。那他有没有什么来头呢？
那
we'll be getting a backstory. Obviously, we know he's gonna be getting his story quest.
这位自称伟大圣龙的酷酷的阿乔，我们大家都称呼他阿乔吧。
AJAW. Google, you need help over there.
和基尼奇是几乎形影不离的。
阿乔，我感觉他的画风跟其他人不太一样啊。那你说长相
？AJAW.Wait. Oh shoot, Jaws.
像这样奇特的阿乔，他是不是性格感觉也很奇怪？我感觉他在之前的影片里面体现出来的那个感觉是挺狂妄自大的。
确实，就是阿乔和基尼奇可以说是
under widely different personalities, obviously.
完全不一样的性格。阿乔的性格特别恶劣，而且大部分时间他都在和基尼奇斗嘴，那么这样的龙伙伴确实也会为基尼奇他自己招致的一些非议。但好像来说，就是基尼奇也不是很在意，就是他并不屑于靠语言来为自己辩白，他总是一个怎么说呢，意志很坚定，目标很清晰，他就是完成自己的委托，然后去向委托人去收取他认为合适的报酬。 而更多关于纪尼奇还有玄牧人的。
And as I just said, we're gonna learn more about him with his story quest.
过去以及他所继承的古名的秘文呢，旅行者们都可以通过我们的部族祭文玄牧人的任务，然后得到进一步的解答。
那同样。
Okay, now we're gonna see his abilities. Let me see.
也轮到我来介绍一下技
能。I love his whole 8-bit style that we're getting for him. It's giving very much 8-bit. I love it. And it's with Dendro, so I'm like, yes.
一起的战斗技能了。那大家也看到。
Oh yeah, he's a Claymore.
他是一个擅长极限运动的这样的一个。
I like his signature weapon though. It's so cool.
一个少年，所以在战斗当中他也会用类似的技能，通过元素战技。
What is this?
快速的移动
啊。
除此以外，他的元素战技在连接到敌人之后
，No, please, I can't with this game. I can't. Look what he's hitting. Look what he's hurting. The babies. He's hurting the babies. The little bums that be waddling with their bellies. Why we gotta hit them? It's Fontaine all over again with my blue potatoes with fins. Oh, I don't want to hurt them, man. I'm over it, man.But oh wait, what is that? What does he have? What is this? Oh snap! Yeah, it is badass. What is not? I'm trying to look at this cool his abilities fighting, but I'm like he's hitting the babies, and my heart hurts. But no, this is cool.
特殊的攻击，并且在合适的时机，它会发射一种很厉害的像手炮一样的这样的一个技能。
Oh, it's like a cannon-like skill. Okay, I was like, he can launch a powerful hand cannon-like skill, not shield.
能叫做回裂灌灵炮。
Called cannon, which can which is quite an edgy name. Okay.
感觉是个很中二的名字，对他瞄准了敌人发出强力的一击，而他释放元素
应该 his elemental burst. I'm like, oh, okay.
爆发的时候呢，在他身边这个好像很性格很恶劣的圣龙阿乔就
，Hey, y'all, look at him up there. He evolved. He went from being two dimensional to three dimensional fighting.Look at him. But oh, that looks so epic though. Okay, I definitely like Kenichi. I love his 8-bit fighting style. The anime is just so good. Like, wow. Now we see why the specs are going up for, I think, did we get like a spec? Like the specs are gonna like have to update because of Notland? I see why.
并且在合适的时机
Oh, wait, let's see his weapon again. Let's see how it looks for a second. But the hand cannon looks sick. I still don't like he's hurting the babies. My heart hurts. But look at his Siggy. I like his Siggy. The signature weapon is even 8-bit. 8-bit like style. I'm like, okay. They're okay. They respond. That's not the point. Tell me they respond.
它会发射一种很厉害的像手炮一样的
But yeah, I will definitely be bagging him. I will definitely be getting him. Of course, he's Dendro, so I'm like, I love me some Dendro. So yeah, he's coming home.
释放吐息来摧毁眼前的敌人
We gotta see what phase is the first phase or the second phase.
啊，
那和其他两位勇士一样，你大概会猜到基尼奇在纳塔的大地上也会具备什么样的能力？
哇，这也太好了吧！就是我们5.0的这三位伙伴都能够帮助我们去收集纳塔的特产。
没错，因为基尼。
And he also too helps collect the specialties. He helps collect materials and Atlant as well for on the mini map. It helps and guides us. Okay, all three of the characters do it. Amazing. So you have like one or two characters, but all three of them in this.5.0, they all can do it. Oh yeah, he's being added to the list. Oh, since you are guaranteed a character, you will be getting him.
He also has the ability to display the Nata Area's special abilities, and apart from that, he also has the ability to display the Shenmue Tribe's special abilities, which is he 他和部分的采集物交互的时候还作为玄牧人部族成员的能力，也就是他和部分的采集物交互的时候还可以去提升。
He can increase the speed, movement speed of all. Oh, when he collects harvestables, he can increase the speed as well. Oh, damn. Okay.
队伍中所有角色的移动速度。
我已经就预见到，就他能够很快加入完战。
I can already see players at quickly adding him to the. You already know. You give him all these perks and.Passes. I'm like, okay, yeah, he coming. He gonna be. I'm pulling him. You ain't gonna keep selling me. You selling me already. Coming.
他的队伍成为大家的
Maybe or you really eating him up. I'm shocked. You're not gonna get him. Well, the maybe. I'm like not for sure gonna be getting him since you eating him up.
助力的这三位角色身上会有特殊的。纹路和怎么说特效，很有一些纳塔的风格，就像周身有火焰在燃烧一样。
Like they have flames burning around them.
的感觉。那这种
，Oh yeah, that. What is this?
设计呢
？This design is a new mechanic that we try with Natlan characters.
其实也是我们在纳塔角色身上所尝试的一种新机制。然后我们把这种机制和那
local lore. Okay, so this is with the lore. Okay.
把本土的一些世界观结合起来，称之为夜。
Called Night Souls Blessing. Okay, so that's what that aura around them is called. Night Souls Blessing.
魂加持哦，那纳塔的角色会利用这种叫夜魂加持的状态，在战斗中充分发。
Night Soul Blessing state in battle fully and showcases their power. Okay.
发挥它的作用，
这种能力，我就接过话茬，是通过我们被称为一种叫做燃素刻录的仪式来激发的。借助一种古老的仪式啊，在纳塔地区，神之眼的持有者不仅可以与部族的大灵和地脉进行沟通，还能通过这个仪式强化自己的实力。
OK， 这个大灵听起来好像是什么部族的监视者，或者像部族。
Oh, we got some new enemies. Lovely.
部族的一个
图腾和信仰这样的。
哦，原来如此。那也就是说，有了夜魂加持这种全新概念的加入，会导致纳塔会有一些完全不一样的体验。
对。
那我们作为设计者呢，其实也对这些体验做了一些便利性的设计。那我们从 5.0 开始。重新制作了一部分且试身手的活动场地，那大家可以看到，就且试身手的场地会变成一个完全是纳塔风格的，类似大世界这样的一个新区域。
哦、oh, ，looks like she does damage though。
重新制作了一部分且试身手的。
Oh, wait, let me read. I was reading it. I was like looking at the her fight. Recreated part of the environment of test run starting.Starting from 5.0.
活动场地，那大家可以
complete all the challenges objectives. Oh, so this is gonna be like the new like testing the characters ground. Well, not well, testing like, the specific character. Oh, I don't know how it's all gonna work. Like with the other characters from the previous ones, when they like rerun them, will they have like are they gonna be like certain area of one of the places in Tibet?One of our other regions, but I like this. So we can like play around with them more instead of having them in this secluded like abyss area fighting. We out in the in a designated area, so we won't obviously go up too far, and just play with the characters and fight with them out in the open. Okay, I like this. The recreating the test run of the characters. Okay.
看到就全身身手的场地会变成一个完全是纳塔风格的类似大世界这样的一个新区域，
世界观察。
旅行者们就可以在这样的一个区域里面很方便的去测试。
Travelers will be able to easily test out characters' abilities in this area. Okay, yeah. Okay, yeah. That's neat.
角色的各项能力啊，进行更深度的游玩和体验。
For more in-depth gameplay and okay, yeah, they definitely they with this one. They.
我知道肯定介绍完这三个角色之后，那大家也会再问一个问题。那旅行者在每个国家，只要他
traveler can gain the element abilities of each nation.
触碰一下七天神像就可以获得这个国家的
just touch of the statue. Yeah, we know the concept from all the other nations.
相关元素
so shouldn't change from this nation.
对这个能力，那么在纳塔，他是不是也能够 很顺利的去接触到火元素的能力，并且也和这些角色一样，有夜魂加持的效果呢？
哎，提到这个就要提前和大家说明一下了。
Clarify this in advance. Oh, clarify what in advance?
那么这次旅行者来到纳塔和七天神像。
When travelers first resonate with the statue of the seventh in that land,
进行初次共鸣的时候呢，由于某种不知
due to some unknown reason,
知名的原因，旅行者并
travelers can't immediately awaken the power of pyro element. Why? What? I wonder why. We so use monstat, animo.Liwe, Geo, Inazuma, Electro, Sumeru, Dendro, Fontaine, Hydro, Natland? They said, no. The statue, when we touch the statue said, you ain't getting it. No. you see, you got it from all these other nations easily. Bitch, no. That's not how I was wearing. You ain't gonna get it like that. You ain't gonna get it that easily. No. The statue's like... I'm not like the other statues of the seven. You ain't gonna get it that easily by just touching me. I'm like, okay, damn, okay, we gotta work. We gotta do something. We don't know why we can't get it, but okay. But yeah, y'all, it seems like we ain't gonna be getting pyro when we first get to Nightland 5.0 for some unknown circumstances. Okay. But hopefully, whenever we do get pyro, Traveler,He better be good. Because Hydro Traveler, we were so stoked in the beginning when 4.0 was like, Hydro Traveler. And then we were disappointed. I was just like, what? Because Hydro Traveler is something else.
不能立刻唤醒火元素力。那关于这个奇怪的现象其实设计。
Crisis. Wait. This strange phenomenon actually...relates to the crisis in that land. It's basically, oh, so it's the crisis that's going on in that land right now, so we can't get the pyro element. Okay, so we gotta figure that out before we can get so we can resonate with pyro. Okay, I wonder, will it be epic since it's involving the story and the nation and all that? I wonder, will it be, hopefully it'd be epic, so it's holding off on this wait to getting it in the previous versions ofthe 5.x series. It better be epic. if you have us hold off until some other patch, it better be eaten. We better be soaring through the sky as a phoenix, plummeting down to the enemies with the beautiful flames of the pyro.
知道了我们现在纳塔面临到的一些种种的危机，那等旅行者们在纳塔的旅程进一步深入的时候，就能够得到详细的解答了。
我相信啊，除了刚才介绍得到这些新朋友啊，还有一些纳塔的角色，因为之前我们有过以凡辽著名的这样的一个视频。
对，
比如说啊，我们还有更早期的一个卫星角色，就是
足迹当中的
对
对
对，就是足迹 PV 里已经露面的伊安山，包括像我有印象的还有恰斯卡，对吧，还有火神这样的角色，那么他们在剧情当中是否都会在 5.0 的版本中登场呢？
哎，七哥就观察得很仔细啊。那么我们先说恰斯卡。
Chaska girl, is that your name?
Chaska, yeah, I was
right. Okay, she's pretty, she's so pretty. We seen her in the teaser.
他是一位来自花语会，个性洒脱，实力傲人，在各个部族中非常文明的调停人这么一个身份。在 5.0 版本的魔神任务当中呢，他也会和我们一起参与到某项重要的调查中。
Investigation.
还有刚才提到的来自于
Our Miss Ma'am, we finally get to see them in action, because obviously we've seen Miss Ma'am already in the teasing of the nations back when the game first came out, which I wasn't playing since, but I've seen the 2020 something teaser of the nations, and they were representing Natland. So we finally get to see them in the game. Cutie.
沃路之邦的我们的健身教练兼微火盛宴巡礼冠军导师伊安山，那他也会在我们的剧情当中为旅行者提供帮助。
那其实刚才在问答环节中啊，大家其实也反复提及的就是
火神还有
对吧，还有元众的第一席队长，就实力最强劲的这一位、那么他们都会在魔神任务中登场吗？第一席队长就实力最强劲的、
Who is the strongest amongst the Fatui? He is the strongest?、After seeing Papa Kino, I'm like, I need to see them all fight. I'm just like, Papa Kino, she almost took out her life with one slice. I'm just like, because I feel like Papa Kino and Capitano can go toe to toe and be like neck and neck.
这一位、那么他们都会在魔神任务中登场吗？
对，也请期待就我们的队长和火神这两位强者对强者之间他们会擦出怎样的火花吧。而在其他引燃
Y'all see how the Pyro Archon flew in like a phoenix?、
对，也请期待就
We better be able to do that
就我们的
with Pyro Traveler. I'm just saying
队长和火
But I'm joking. Not you asking for a lot. Am I? It's just being reasonable. And I say that. I'm just throwing out a theory. We don't know. It's speculation. We will see what they're going to throw at us for Pyro Traveler.
火神这两位强者对强者之间他们会擦出怎样的火花吧。而在其他引燃 PV 中出现的角色，就比如说来自我们回声之子的
When we going to be seeing her? I really want to see her. What's her name? I want to meet her.Xylanin. But yeah, she is so cute.
希诺宁，来自烟迷主的希特拉利，还有欧洛伦等等，他也会在后续的版本中陆续与各位旅行者们见面。那么在介绍完角色之后呢，就接下来拜托我们鸡哥揭晓一下。
We're getting to the character event wishes. Let's see.We're gonna be able to make s'mores.
角色活动祈愿的具体安排吧。
终于到了大家万众期待的环节哦。那好，那就这次还是由我来给大家介绍一下 5.0 版本。
Let's see the events.
的祈愿活动安排。那么在 5.0 版本的第一阶段，
Okay. She's in the first phase. Okay. So we got Mulani. Am I saying her name right? Mulani.Mulani. Oh, not the capital child.
Mulani.
Yeah, Mulani. Got Mulani, and then we got Kazuha. Ooh, child. Not to put in Kazuha in the mix. Ooh, because I know some people want Kazuha for who don't have him yet. And then, of course, Kachina. She's going to be the four star, so hopefully.Y'all get her. Y'all gonna get a copy of her first if you play through the Natlan Archon quest. So, yeah. But if you're not, if you didn't get to that part yet, it's gonna take a minute. So, hopefully, if you pull on the baron, you get her. But y'all know, I'm be pulling for her. Get my primos stacked after Emily almost took all my primos. If you wanna see that video, I'll put it up in the thing up there. Emily.Almost sucked me dry. But yeah. So I'm on a 50-50. So hopefully she come home early. Yeah. And you already know I got Kazuha already. And again, if you want to see that video, it'll be up there in the thing, chill. I was getting Kazuha with I'll Hate Them. And it was a trip.
就是上半段，我们的马拉尼和风游万叶都将会迎来概率 up， 然后卡奇娜呢，她也会出现在第一阶段的两个活动起源当中，并且提升获取概率。而在卡池的下半期
，In second phase， we got the Raiden Shogun， we got Mr. Raiden Shogun herself， and Kinich is in second phase， obviously， I'll be getting him as well.I'm not gonna say much about that. I'm already getting him. And Miss Red and Shogun. So for the people who don't got the Electro Archon herself, aka Red and Shogun, another difficult one. I'm just like, again, for the people who want to get her and then who want to get the new character from that land, it's gonna be, we're gonna see. We will see. I already got Miss A herself, and again, I'll put the thing up there for y'all to go see me pulling for her, because she was another one that did me in badly. So yeah, crazy. Oh, she's an R. Yes, she's an R card. You're gonna be meeting her real soon, since you're in Inazuma Archon Quest. You'll be meeting her real soon. Yeah.
将会迎来基尼奇和雷电将军的概率up。哎，旅行者们可千万不要错过哦。此外呢，全新五星双手剑山。And
we got the weapons.
王长牙和五星法器冲浪时光也将出现在武器。Now
they call her weapon surfs up. They said we're gonna make this name easy. Surfs up. That's it. But her, I love her catalyst. It's really cute. It got like a little. Is that a bird or a fish in the mouth of the big fish? Cute. And then of course we got Kenichi's weapon, which looks so good, so sick. Fang of the Mountain King. I don't know, I'm gonna be pulling on weapon banners. I don't know. But it looks so cool though.
五星双手剑、山王长牙和五星法器冲浪时光也将出现在武器活动起源中。同时，纳塔地区也新增了五把可。
Oh yeah, I forgot we get forgeable weapons from every like nation, so we can these weapons that we can like obviously craft forge in Natland. Ooh, I gotta see what these do, because I might have to have alternate for Kenichi Siki and Miss Mulani Siki.
锻造武器，旅行者们可以前往纳塔的铁匠铺，寻找阿龙进行兑换。那在接下来的前瞻的一系列的活动中，
what events we're getting?
出一个名为"出发火之国的 H5王"。
Oh, what is this? What is this, honey? We will be launching a web event called Off We Go to Natland of Pyro. Oh, this is offline. Oh, it's not obviously offline. This is web event. Okay. Trip with the new Nana weapons. So what this entails?
那参与这个网页活动呢，旅行者不但能够直
Crabs will not only get a look into the new content.
不断的了解到即将上线的5.0版本的新内容，还能在版本更新后直接
Oh wait, that went by fast.
接通过这个渠道，即将上线的5.0版本的新内容还能在版本
But also directly obtain the three. Oh wait, directly, but also to directly obtain the three forgeable weapons. Oh, so that's what. What does this event do? You will get the forgeable weapons for free without having to craft them, forge them. Oh, that's neat. Okay. So it's either will we get the spear? Well, depending on if we hit the marks or not, we get the spear, pole arm, catalyst, and the claymore, and something else, and some other goodies. So okay.
旅行者不但能够直观的了解到即将上线的5.0版本的新内容，还能在版本更新后直接通过这个 H5的玩法。
Sadly, the sword and the bow have to sit out for this one. They said we couldn't do too much, y'all, we giving y'all this, but y'all can't get the sword and the bow. They said, y'all gotta forge that one yourselves. Those two.
获取三种纳塔地区的锻造武器。那所有关于直接通过这个
take part in the web event to attain three types of forgeable weapons from that line after the version update event duration August 22nd to September 24th.
H5的玩法获取三种纳塔地区的锻造武器。那所有关于这些活动的具体内容呢，也请关注官方后续的公告，了解更多的活动详情。那除了刚才说的全新的武器以外呢，5.0版本更新以后啊，我们
new artifacts. Don't forget about these new artifacts. We gotta do more farming for artifacts. I love that. But no, these are really. I love the designs on these.
还会增加两套全新的圣遗物。 他们叫做进城勇者会卷和黑曜密点，那这两个名字一听就很像是纳塔本土的
那种风格。
对，那旅行者们也可以在纳塔挑战全新的诸圣秘境来获取这两套圣遗物。那我一口气讲了这么多应该没有漏掉什么吧，我觉得
那就是我们的新角色，然后我们的新武器还有圣遗物的部分也就到此为止告一段落了。
嗯，没错。
那么我也圆满完成了今天的任务
啊，
那我也要追随大伟哥。
所以说大伟哥今天台上就只剩我一个人了吗？
你可以自己想办法呀。
啊，我自己想办法吗？好，那我就先不说了，我待会去邀请一下我的小伙伴们来现场来撑撑面子。嗯，行，那请大家拭目以待。
This must be your first time in Natland. Chief says Natland's a little different from other nations because we live in separate tribes rather than having one main city.But every time the pilgrimage rolls around, all six tribes gather at the stadium to compete and find the strongest warriors.
Can't wait to see the other tribes, because we're only seeing obviously two right now they're showing us, but I want to see the other three. Yeah, the six. Adam, yeah, the other three tribes.
See those people with the tepetlosaurs? They're from my tribe. I come from the Children of Echoes. We're known for our mining skills. The Tepetlosaurs are our friends.
The mining boys
too. They help us find the prettiest ores and gems.
Oh.
And that means my tribe has all the best jewelers. When we find a really special gemstone, we use it to decorate our weapons or jewelry. Oh, also, if you have time, you should come watch one of our dance-offs. They're super fun.
Nothing having dance offs.
You saw are from the people of the springs.
That's right. We live alongside the Koholosaurus. Our
Koholosaurus.
Tribe is a really awesome vacation spot. Oh, sorry. Got lost in the music for a sec.
Girl, same. I'm loving the music. Come on.
The people of my tribe love getting together to go fishing, listen to music, and relax. Beyond that,favorite thing is bathing in the hot springs.
I was wondering when they're gonna get to this. I was about to say, I remember Nuvi, he told us at the end of the Fontaine art, was it? Yeah, it was like towards the end. Nuvi told us about the hot springs in Natland. We're gonna run into the springs. The hot springs.
The Koholosaurus like it too.That's why we're such good pals. But make sure you give him some space when it gets busy. And if a grumpy Koholosaur bites you, do not bite them back.
Oh?
A lot of places in Natland are covered in lava. If you plan to go exploring, I recommend picking a guide from my tribe. For deliveries, look no further than the Scions of the Canopy.
Scions of the Canopy.
We've got a lot of messengers.Everything from letters to packages. Being quick on our feet is one of our strengths. There's also our hunters, who take on a wide range of commissions.
Ha! Look! Those idiots have a bigger death wish than you!
Extreme sports are popular in my tribe.
Just jump up there.
Don't worry, the Yunkasaurs will protect them. This region is inhospitable. Young people from my tribe come here because they like a challenge. Next up, there's...
Wait, look, the competition's starting.
Not her interrupting, like, we're not showing off the other tribes yet. We still gotta, we're just paying attention to these three tribes right now. We ain't worried about the other ones yet. They still keep it hush hush on them other tribes. For some reason. Are you gonna lie down? Oh, Carl.
Next time then.
Who's gonna come out on top this time? I can't wait.
But no, that was so cute. I love learning about the three tribes. And what they do. Get y'all coats. I want the blanket. I want the blanket. I want one of these blankets. Where y'all get them? Where y'all get them from? I want one.
好，各位旅行者，欢迎回来。那在这个环节呢，我就不是鸡哥了，在这个环节我是逆夜龙鸡哥。那我的小伙伴现在也已经到场了，他们到底是人？
Wait, let me see something real quick. I know it's not live anymore. Let me reset and see where I'm at. Oh my god.
Ladies.
Ooh, 2 hours, child. Where am I in this 2 hours? Oh, I'm not even halfway there. Ooh.
Young people from my tribe come here because they like a challenge.
来介绍一下你们自己。回来。
We still got a little bit more to go.
Hey.
It's 2 hours and 15 minutes. 各位旅行者，
欢迎回来。那在这个环节呢，我就不是鸡哥了。在这个环节，我是逆夜龙鸡哥。那我的小伙伴现在也已经到场了。那他们到底是人还是龙啊？哎，说你们呢，别睡了，别睡了，别睡了，节目都开始了。
睡得真香啊！
机会难得。
And they got the plushie of the baby.
你们给大家介绍一下你们自己。
大家好，我是疾风龙啊，不对，我是原神的战斗设计师老杨。平时的主要工作呢，主要是做龙。然后今天呢，很高兴能到现场给大家亲自做一次龙。
哎，大家好，我是原神的关卡设计师小八，很荣幸呢，这次能够和大家介绍一下，纳塔的场景和关卡设计理念。
欢迎两位。好，那今天啊，我们请到小八还有老杨来到现场呢，其实是我们接着刚才的话题继续聊。我们已经知道了呀，就纳塔是一个人和龙共生的国度。那刚才其实我们在之前的介绍里也有谈到说，哎，纳塔的地貌环境啊，其实也跟其他的国家非常的不一样。
哎，是的，我也其实也在网上看到了很多这样的评论。对于我们开发者来讲呢，纳塔也是一个非常具有特色的国度，潮酷和多彩是它的两个关键词。比方说，旅行者可以在巨大的山体上面看到
，Travelers can see colorful graffiti on massive mountains. Yes, and I love that. It's so pretty.
多彩的涂鸦。
Different color of the leaves and everything, giving very much forward vapes.
或者是说在各个部落里面看到很多潮酷的要素。
哎，那这次我注意到一件事啊，就是老杨你怀里抱的这是个什么？
这应该是我们纳塔会。
So cute. Where, when is it gonna be for sale? When? So cute.
随时陪着我们在任务中的一个。小伙伴，就是在纳塔，我们已经知道它是一个人和龙结合的国度，所以我们整个的设计理念是围绕着人和龙怎么做的结合。
没错，那上一趴我也有说到啊，就是旅行者可以通过一种附身的方式来附到纳塔的龙类身上，从而进行一些复杂的探索的行为。
那接下来我就替老杨来介绍一下这位非常可爱的小伙伴吧。
哦，他也有什么来头吗？
旅行者们在纳塔探险的时候呢，就会遇到这一只特别的小疾风龙，我们暂时称它为小家伙吧。小家伙呢，它会陪伴我们经历很多有趣的小故事，并且也会参与到重要的世界任务当中哦。
那
，It's a world quest. Okay, so he can be a world quest. 哦、oh. ，
除了这个小疾风龙这个小家伙以外啊，那我知道就是，刚才你也有谈到纳塔有非常多的部落的特色。那其实今天也很难得，我们有三个小龙人在场，对吧？不如这次我们就眼见为实，带着玩家去逛一圈。
好呀，
可以啊，来来来，我们先去我们疾风龙的部落去看一下我的老家。
走走走，跟着他
走吧。走吧，
这里啊就是我们回声之子的部落。
哦。
大家可以看到啊，我们这个地方有很多的宝石，
也有很多的矿石。
同时呢，我们整个建筑的风格也看起来就跟岩元素很有关系。
那已经是他们了，已经
代入了。
是的，我们回声之子啊，一直觉得最强的战士，比如说像我这样的，才能够获得最好的宝石。所以呢，我们去深耕了一下挖掘相关的一些技术。
我来为老杨补充一下，就是在回声之子周围呢，也有不少因为钻探和挖掘而被发现的奇特景观，比如这处巨大的含有大量固态元素的鎏金之脉，
以及一些很神秘的可以一直向下挖掘的洞穴等等。
哎，你刚才其实小八有提到啊，有很多值得去挖掘的区域，你刚才也说对吧，你们部落是以宝石和挖掘做建长的，那你们的战斗伙伴也就是疾风龙想必也非常擅长这个领域的一些能力吧。
疾风龙虽然在地面上移动看起来憨态可掬，但是借助燃素它可以在地下快速的移动，还能翻山越岭，同时也能帮我们回声之子去探查地下什么地方有宝石。
所以他应该是你们这个部落的跑酷好手了。
哎，是的。
哎，你看小八那边还有一处好像是你们部落的。
是的，这是我的老家，接下来不如到我的老家去看一下吧。
没问题，那你来带路。
哇，这里呢就是我的老家齐游龙部族流泉之众。就咱部落的人呢是大多是热爱音乐，然后
Music lovers, I know the music sounds good, slaps a bit.
以及喜欢泡泡温泉休闲放松，然后包括他们的伙伴
Another little baby.
欧龙呢日常也是一副懒散甚至有那么一点迟钝的样子，虽然我们部族的人呢经常看起来是这么一副安逸的样子，但当遇到真正的战斗以及比赛的时候也都是一把好手。值得一提的是呢，咱部族的人也是纳塔少数的能够在液态燃素区域上活动的人。
液态燃素是不是就是那种看起来特别像岩浆的那种区域？
对对对，我记得，因为之前我们也提到过液态燃素。那小八给我们再介绍一下。
好的啊，液态燃素区域呢是我们看起来是比较像橙红色，很热，甚至有一点危险的这种地区。
哎，那既然它这么危险的话，是不是我在周边游玩的时候要特别小心才行？
其实也不用。因为液态燃素区域呢它通常是在比较隐秘的地下，或者说存在在一些比较有挑战性的区域，需要喜欢挑战的旅行者们。
They're most for travelers to explore adventurous. You know that's me love to go venturing, stumbling upon areas, so yeah, it's very challenging area, zones. Okay, so
或者说存在在
一
些比较有挑战性的区域，需要喜欢挑战的旅行者们呢自己前去体验。
我们两个都说差不多了，鸡哥觉得缺点什么？
那接下来就去看看我的老家，也就是聂龙的部族怎么样。
好呀，
行，那我来带路。
哎，这是什么呀？
嘿嘿，
这可是聂龙部落的宝藏，这是地图。哎，既然大家看到了聂龙部族这边有一个这么大的聂龙头像，那不如我们就从龙本身开始说起吧。
可以啊，看一下跟我们疾风龙还有小八他们齐游龙究竟有什么不同。
没问题。那聂龙呢，它最强大的能力当然就是自己觅食的能力了。大家就看见啊，在聂龙的夹带当中其实储存了一种很特殊的叫做火硫果胶的物质。那每当聂龙要去觅食的时候呢，就会释放夹带当中的火硫果胶，用它粘住果实然后送入口中。那在纳塔当然也会有一些富含燃素的果实，那聂龙呢也可以通过火灵果胶去吸收这些带有燃素的果实，并且在适当的时候去释放它们，造成爆炸的效果。这种火硫果胶呢，它
This hit his own kind. Wait a minute, hold on, back that up.
那每当聂龙要去觅食的时候呢，就会释放夹带当中的火硫果胶，用它粘住果实，然后送入。
Which sticks to fruit.Sort of fruit which they then stick into their mouth.
口中，那在纳塔当然也会有。
You know, there are also many kinds of fruit rich in.
有一些富含燃素的果实，那聂龙呢也可以通过火灵。
Can you absorb the loaded fruit.
果胶去吸收这些带有燃素的果实，并且在适当的时候
It releases them to create an explosion effect when needed. OK.
去释放它们，造成爆炸的效果。这种火硫果胶呢，它不仅能够作为觅食的手段，在其他的时段里面，它还可以作为聂龙在山峦之间来回穿梭的这样的一个媒介。
那既然聂龙这么厉害，他们部族的人呢？
哎，那么这不得不说，聂龙部族叫玄木人，所有的部族成员呀，他们都非常热衷于极限运动，也会和他们的龙伙伴一样，在群山当中来回穿梭。所以呢，聂龙部族也就是玄木人部族的成员，他们多半呀，也都成为了冒险家、运动员，或者说快递人这样的一些职业。
What are these fluff balls? What are these? What are these fluff things? Squishiness? What is this?
在聂龙部族旁边。
Oh, pretty area.
那其实有这么一个遍布高耸悬崖的遗迹，祖茵庙宇。
It's an alpaca. They probably call it something different in the game, but we do it. I do like it.
和聂龙一起呢，旅行者说不定可以找到神秘的宝藏哦。
鸡哥呀，我还是非常在意刚才说的吃果子这个事儿。我听过一个关于你们聂龙的八卦，不知道你听过没有？
我感觉不是什么好八卦。
我听说有一只聂龙平时不是很自律，然后呢，因为吃了太多的果子，导致身材发福，在洞穴下面再也回不来了。鸡哥，你可一定得保重啊！
啊，原来是这么一回事。那我觉得呀，这里面可有太多的新闻你不知道了。所以老杨，我们不如我们坐回去。就这件事情我跟你们再好好说道说道。好，哎，老杨，就接着刚才那个聂龙的话题啊，我觉得我必须要为他说句公道话。虽然这只聂龙他又贪吃，体型又大，确实也困在一个地方出不来，但是呢，他实际上是聂龙当中非常古老的一只。哎，那你就会问了，我们旅行者到底用什么方式来对付他们呢？那这一点确实老杨刚才说的有道理啊，就是他确实贪吃，所以旅行者们呢，在跟他对战的过程中可以找到一些对付他的弱点，比如说他喜欢吃的东西，对吧？
我觉得鸡哥更像是在给自己辩解啊。
那一定没有这个意思，一定没有。哎，对啊，那我还不得不说一句啊，这个聂龙的 boss 长上去还是挺可爱的。难道我们纳塔就全都是这种可爱画风的龙吗？就像我们三个一样
啊？那肯定不止。就像我们之
那 what is this boss
之前在宣传短片中提前放出的，有一只会飞的大龙。这个龙呢，其实也是我们5.0版本旅行者需要面对的一个敌人。
哎，但是我怎么记得纳塔的龙好像一般都是聚居的，为什么这只龙它会自己单独跑出来呢？
啊，你也看出来它跟我们现在我们三
We know he's different from the other three of us.
三个是不
I wonder is this the one from the other tribes probably?
不太一样了。这只巨大的家伙呢是有一些特殊的原因的，这个地方我要先卖个关子。然后它
Oh, did it just shapeshift?
他不得已而为之，最后离开了自己的族群，生活在这片区域。啊，除了刚
Oh wow，
才我们介绍过的这个胖胖的聂龙和神秘的巨大飞龙呢，我们在纳塔的旅程中还有许多神奇的生物，比如说看上去就
What is the look at the belly? I just keep seeing all these cute. Cute animal with the bellies, I love it. It's so cute. I just wanna squeeze.
就很容易被撞飞的鸟，看上去就很憨的。
Capybara, that's a capybara. Capybara, 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 capybara. Very much. Capybara.
魂兽，看上去就很热的甲虫。
What is this? Oh.
龙，还有一些看上去就很会飞的老鼠。
Oh, flying squirrels.
除了刚才老杨讲到的这些奇特生物以外呢，在纳塔还有很多风格迥异的场景，比如说神秘的高兰。
What is this? This is the mysterious and challenging night's trial.
度的夜神试炼，还有
What is that, honey?
巨大的间歇喷发的火山，未来呢也会给旅行者们开放。
Oh, volcano. Which will open.To travelers in the future. So, next version 5.1, 5.2, probably will be going there. 5.3, who knows? 5.4?
这个大家可以尽情期待。
大家都知道我们在每个国家推出的时候都会有一套叫声望系统的系统内容。那这一次在 5.0 的版本我们对这个声望系统做了一次全新的尝试。那这一次呢，旅行者可以在各个部落的一个叫药石图腾柱的地方去接取对应部族的讨伐悬赏和误区通告。
哎，那这听上去不还是声望系统吗？
鸡哥，你别骗我。
对，我好像说到这里感觉它跟声望系统没有什么区别啊。但是呢，我还是说漏了一点。在之前的环节当中，我有提到一个叫部族祭文的概念。那么在药石图腾柱这里，旅行者们还可以开启每个部族的部族祭文了。这个祭文呢，除了包含部族的传说和周边的风土人情以外，还有大家最关心的纳塔的角色传说任务。也就是说，包含上述所有的内容在内，每一个部族都将陆续开放3个章节供玩家游玩。
所以我们纳塔的传说任务
其实是换了一种新的形式出现的。
除了部落巨温以外，外呢，在5.0版本还有更多以单元剧形式。
Also features more short world quests. Oh, short, yes.
出现的篇幅比较短的世界任务，比方说刚才介。
For example, the world quest featuring Little One was just
介绍到的以小家
so cute
阿慧为主角的世界
Look at him
任务。
好好好，那我们一口气介绍了这么多的包括场景。
Okay, but yeah, the thing they're doing shorter world quests because sometimes, child, especially y'all and from people who obviously Genshin, Sumeru, you already know which one I'm talking about. The R&R quest. I don't want to talk about it. It was that just, it was so long. It was so cute getting to know the R&R and unlocking their places and getting like, it was amazing, but child, it was so long and drawn out.I was like, oh my god, it's still going. it was so, oh my god. I was like, it was never going to end. So good thing now they won't be long in not lying, child. I'm like, I cannot.
包括我们战斗的一些 boss 呀，包括刚才说的任务。那么接下来我们再跟旅行者们介绍一下这次5.0版本的活动。
好呀，那就由我来为大家介绍一下我们。
Now getting introduced to the events.
我们的活动吧，这次我们也为旅行者们准备了很多丰。
Oh wait, there's so many. So, oh, we got that one. We got that one with the enemies. We got that one, Memories of Teyvat. And then we got that one. We got Doroko. And we got the Ley Lines Overflow.
丰富多彩的活动，比如纳塔探索的导览，还有前往提瓦特各处打卡的。
Oh yeah.We obviously be able to get that event that just helps us around the new area. Just like in Fontaine, we have one. And I think in Samira, we have one. We had to take photos of everything. So yeah. So none of that. The first one up there in the top. Always get us to know around a new area. Or is it the app one over there on the left?I feel that one, Paimon Zen.
的旅行回顾，完成其中一个活动呢，还能获得一个四星法器。值得一提。
Oh yeah, it is that one then up there.
接着是，即使旅行者们已经游玩过的一些挑战呢，在纳塔也会以一个完全不同的形式呈现。
这里我要替他说一句，我们也为旅行者准备了一些特殊的游玩的短片。哦。具体有多不一样，我们一起看一下就知道了。
好，那我们就看一看。
好。
这次呢，我们纳塔呢带来了很多全新的玩法，今天也邀请了几个朋友到现场来实际体验一下。我就先带着大家跑一段现实挑战。这个地方有一个龙灵，这是疾风龙部落的，然后我们可以魂附到这个龙灵上，就可以开始我们的挑战了。进去以后呢，开右扳机，你就钻到地下。在这个过程里面呢，我们需要借助我们这个小龙的特点啊，去尽可能多的吃到金币。这就是个错误示范。这个地方呢，又要切回我们疾风龙了。
墙上这个红色的石头是
负能量的。
哦。
还行还行。
厉害厉害，
一百一百，也就是101-101吧。
That's fine。
咱们教学也就先告一段落，立刻进入比赛，怎么样？
来了，实战环节。
咱两两组队，互相比一下挑战用时和挑战得分。
漏了。
我怎么感觉我上来就漏了？
感觉我们有戏了。
然后上去，分析，
是不是漏了一个？
那你要相信我，
你转头看看呗，
你漏不了。
哎
哎，
我怎么感觉我下面又漏了？来，准备到你了啊！
来了来了
来了，
给给
给！哎，等话来了。
哎，
打开了人数视野，
不愧是我教的呀。
哎
哎，
咱先把它跑，哎，对，回到正轨，可以可以。
哦，
第一次嘛，还可以，最高评分应该是 B。
那必须的。耶、yeah?。
压力逐渐减小。
攻击攻击，准备要接手了，交吗？
啊，怎么不换好给我？
加油加油！哎，高阶操作了。
哎 ，so good。
不好意思啊，拿了个最低评分，
一般一般，也没满嘛，对不对？
那个
原神5.0版本也即将上线，马上就给旅行者们端上来了，到时候我们大家一起去纳塔去体验这些新鲜的玩法吧，
期待。
Yeah, that game plan looks fun.
欢迎回来，哇，我终于从逆夜龙的形态解脱了。那坐在我身边的呢，就是大家的老朋友，原神的国内市场负责人 Michael。
大家好，
这次说来也巧啊。我们的5.0版本刚好撞上周年庆啊！
是，那说起周年庆，那就必须带上我们的传统技能。
没错，那么在这次5.0版本期间呢，通过周年庆的签到活动，我们会为各位旅行者送出10枚纠缠之源。另外，
Of course we getting our usual the login, cause only to collect to get the total of intertwined fates 10, and then of course the in mail.1,600 primos, and we get a little new pet, little friend. So that's cute.
我们也会通过邮件向大家发放包括1,600元石在内的诸多奖励，其中还包含一个全新的跟宠和一个有趣的炸弹玩具小道具哦。
那接下来必须还有
啊，对对对，我们也会在这个版本去重置大家的首充双倍福利。
嗯，那福利的环节就到这里。那接下来让我来介绍一下。
等等
啊，
那福利的环节为什么就到这里了？
我们每年的福利不是都还有吗？
哎，难道大伟哥没有跟你讲过吗？
啊，他跟我讲什么了？
那么这个你见过吗？
这什么？这么厚吗？
Michael， 你真不知道吗？
真不知道。
别慌，别慌，别慌。那我们就带入 Michael 的视角，我们和旅行者们一起来一条一条分享一下我们这个版本做出的福利以及相关优化。在5.0版本期间，旅行者们只要完成魔神任务。
Wait, join in the details for complete the Argon quest.
荣花与炎日之徒，也就是我们5.0版本。
Wait, complete. Oh wait, collect.What? You get 500.
期间，旅行者们只要完成魔神任务《荣花与炎日之徒》，也就是我们5.0。
That is our main story. Will receive additional premiums 500 directly from the event interface.
那主线就可以在活动界面直接领取额外的500元石。
刚刚说到的是完成主线就有更多的原石吗？
没错啊。
那还有提到一点是5.0版本期间才有，那是只有5.0才有吗？
哎，那可不是了，在接下来的5.0、5.1和5.3版本，也就是我们的主线。
Wait, imagine they did they gave us if they doing that doing this now, it does it for all the other, the past ones, the Archon quests. That would be amazing, but that would have been too much primos on our hands if they did that for all the other for all the Archon quests. I'm just like, you gonna do the past ones?
现重要篇章发布的这些版本，都可以拿到这样的限时奖励，也就是有更多的额外的500元石哦。
我感觉还是有一些吸引力哦。
我刚才有讲到魔神任务啊，那接下来我当然要去讲一讲传说任务了。在后续的新角色，无论他们是以部族祭文还是以传说任务的形式出现他们的故事的时候，只要玩家在当前的版本进行了这些任务的体验，就可以获得额外的奖励了。
那具体有哪些奖励？
哎，这些奖励包含额外的原石，以及还有对应角色突破等级2和突破等级3所需要的所有培养材料哦。我们就拿5.0版本的马拉尼来举例子， 首先我们会有写誓身手的活动，马拉尼可以突破到突破等级一，对不对？嗯。然后因为马拉尼有部族祭文任务
，Sixty Primos， 来 ，Travis will receive level. Oh, wait, Travis will receive level materials needed to level her up to Ascension 2. Phase 2 and 3. Oh, dang. Okay. Oh, this is amazing. Oh. Would it be happening to all the characters new and up until now? Or, well, obviously, if rerun characters happen and all that, will they do this? Or is it just, like, new characters? But this is amazing. Like, get materials, descending them from Phase 2 to 3. I'm like...
也就是说接下来他还会陆续获得突破等级二和突破等级三的所有材料，也就是说玩家几乎不用付出任何的额外。
This means players can level up to level 60 quickly with almost no extra effort. Okay, okay. Okay, I like that. We just have to get the rest of the material. Okay, I like that.
努力，他就能直接将马拉尼快速升到六十级。嗯，
那说明现在养新角色的这个培养压力就一下子下来了。
没错，这样也是能够为我们的。
It helps new and old players overcome many obstacles. Thank you for caring about that. Thank you. But me still gonna be still pre-farming a little bit though.
新老玩家第一次接触到新角色的时候，就是能铺平很多原先遇到的阻碍。
但是，对于新加入的这些旅行者，他们好像不能立刻赶到纳塔。对于他们，有什么样的安排？
那 Michael， 你的意思是说，假如我是一个初来乍到的旅行者，
对的，
我没有办法第一时间体会到这些任务，那我就拿不到对应的人士奖励了。
是的，
这一点我们当然也都考虑到了。所以在后面呢，我们也开放了一个新的功能，是主线快速开启功能。在 5.0 版本更新以后，只要
After the version 5.0 update, as long as the characters complete Lee Wei's Archon Quest,
完成了黎月的主线魔神任务，并且达到了冒险等级
，and reaching AR 28
二十八级，就可以直接在
They can unlock Natland's Archon Quest in the event.Interface directly. Oh, okay. Okay, okay, okay. Okay. So that means y'all, so people are not already like caught up like with the other Archon Quests after Lee Wei's, which is Inazuma, Sumeru, and Fontaine. You can like just go right to Natland and get, and start that. And you can get, Kachina.If you like, we're like, well, just get her for free and play around with her. Okay.
活动界面开启纳塔的主线剧情了。
Really good for new players.
就是之前还有一些朋友会问我嘛，什么时候入坑原神最好？那我觉得就是现在了。
哎，我还要给大家补充一条信息哦，就是快速开启的这个功能在后续版本也会陆续开启。
那让我再追问一下吧，之前忙碌在外的一些旅行者，或许会返回到提瓦特大陆再看一看。那对于我们这些回归的老朋友，是不是也应该有些表示啊？
你知道在原神原先的版本里面有一个针对回归玩家的活动，叫星之归还。对，那么在 5.0 版本呢，我们对星之归还的奖励也做了一定的调整。除了原本的原始奖励以外呀，还有一些长期没有回归到提瓦特的旅行者们，那这些旅行者呢还会额外
receive a ten roll。Interface intertwine fates 10 as extra rewards in the celebrate reunion. It's always a 10, 20, 30.
新之归还
is that given too much?
活动中领取至多十枚纠缠之源，
十抽啊！
对，具体的参与规则呢，旅行者可以参考后续的官方公告和游戏内的指引。
等等。那新玩家跟老朋友都照顾到了，
没错、啊。
那像我这种一直坚守在提瓦特旅程一线的旅行者， 我们也提了很多的优化意见跟想法，那有没有针对我们的一些内容呢？
那当然了，我们一直在强调，其实原神的开发组啊一直在持续的关注和倾听玩家的反馈，那么接下来我还有更多的调整和优化就是针对玩家的反馈所做出的。在 5.0 版本更新以后呢，只要旅行者们点击背包当中对应区域特产的野外采集选项，我不知道大家有没有注意过啊，就是区域特产一直有一个只可观看不可点击的野外采集地点推荐，
没错，
对。那么现在呢，只要你点击了这个选项，它就会在大地图上自动追踪这些。
Oh, this is gonna be helpful. This is gonna be helpful. I've seen this in the dev thing they released on Twitter. I've seen this. I was like, thank goodness gracious, we have this. So we'll have to keep using the. Well, you can still obviously use the website map that they forgot what it's called, but yeah, the map on the web to use, but now you can just use this and you know the area where the materials are. That is so helpful.
这些区域特产的采集地点了。不仅如此，你还可以通过这个自动追踪功能来监控这些区域里面剩余特产的可采集数量。
哇，那也太舒服了吧。那怪物的掉落的这个能不能也做一下优化？以前我去收集这个海乱鬼跟漂浮灵的时候真的太痛苦了。
那么在这一次啊，我们也针对这样的一个反馈做了一些调整。在 5.0 版本更新以后呢，我们特定的一些怪物的材料掉率也会获得提升，其中啊就包括 Michael 你刚才提到的海浪鬼和漂浮灵。
那怎么样提升啊？
大家可以看到我们视频上面的一些掉落素材的对比啊。
对，Come on, Papa Kino.
好明显。
对，当然如果只是提升他们的掉率可能还不能满足玩家除大地的一个需求啊，所以在 5.0 版本我们还推出了另外一个功能，我们推出了开放世界等级的世界等级。
We have launched a world level 9 in the open world. Level 9, love that.
9,
世界等级9吗？
没错。那么大家会想啊，世界等级9会不会非常
That's right, you might wonder if the world level 9 could be too challenging.
很困难，但是对于这些
But for these powerful travelers,
实力强大的旅行者，他可以很轻松的。
They can easily, the continent of the world 9. I'm gonna test it out and see can I do it. I'm gonna see.
挑战世界等级九的这些内容的同时呢，还会获得更丰厚的
and receive even more abundant drops rewards. Okay, we get 5. Okay, I might we'll see. I might level up to 5.I got some cracked characters, I guess.
掉落奖励，我必须要强调一下，这些掉落奖励呢，也包含首领敌人在内。
The drop rates include the boss enemies. Okay, we get 3.
等等，让我捋一捋。那就是说，刚刚世界等级提升后的这个增加材料的掉落，以及包括整体的这个怪物掉落的这个内容的增加，两个效果是可以叠加的吗？
没错，这两个效果是完美叠加的，所以 Michael 你的理解能力很强啊。
哇真那有点不得了啊。
Michael 你已经听到这里了，难道你不觉得
那这样吧，我还有一些痛点，就我必须要今天就替玩家去说。剩一物我也一直觉得应该优化的。那你们有安排吗？
那当然了，那当然了。就是圣遗物啊，我觉得大家这么多年下来啊，对于原神的圣遗物主要是吐槽两个点啊。就是第一个点叫圣遗物转狗粮。第二个点叫一个极品圣遗物的胚子。我们先说圣遗物分解的事情啊。旅行者们在分解圣遗物之前不是只能分解出摩拉吗？那么这次啊，我们分解圣遗物之后可以将它转化为圣遗物的经验素材了，也就是说大家不用再担心说不舍得分解这些圣遗物而占大家的背包空间了。
哎，我以前就是因为有一些生命磁条跟防御磁条不知道应不应该把它拿掉，所以我一直都存着，我的背包是一直满的状态。
对，然后存着的时候呢，你又不太愿意把它直接换成摩拉。
对，万一后面有角色要用到，那 对吧？我也不知道。
没错，好。那刚才 Michael 其实提了一个很重要的问题啊，就是他如果到了关键的时候，却又没有办法为后续的角色获取对应的圣遗物，就会感觉自己很矛盾，对不对？
对的，
那么除了圣遗物转化为培养材料以外呢，我们还推出了第二个很重磅的功能，叫做祝圣之霜。
祝圣之霜
，What's called？
对，Sanctifying Elixir. Okay.
Thank you. Go go.
这个名字听起来有点厉害。
这个名字听起来很厉害，它的功能其实更厉害。旅行者们可以通过使用祝圣之。
Oh, so we can pick. It's just like the thing you have in Honkai Star Rail. We can use and get this. To get specific relics.Now they put it in here. Oh, good. Hey, you can pick substats. Two of them at least.
霜来兑换指定词条的圣遗物。
指定词条吗？
没错，这个指定词条不仅能够指定主词条的属性种类，还可以额外指定两个副词条的属性。
副词条也能？
没错。
那我的双爆岂不是？
对。
那个 double crit，
跟你想的一样。5.0 版本的铸成之霜呢，大家。
而且 can be obtained by exchanging a number of upgraded artifacts。
可以通过萃取一定数量已经升级的圣遗物，或者说探索纳塔的大世界，或者。
Or exploring, I think they said we're exploring.
可以通过萃取一定数量已经升级的圣遗物，或者说探索纳塔的大世界，或者说
哦 me busy looking at the thing，
萃取一定数量已经升级的圣遗物，或者说
or exploring that land open world，
探索纳塔的大世界，或者说解锁
or unlocking wait is that the battle pass？
我们的珍珠纪行达到指定的
yeah the battle pass， I think that's the $20 one， wait is it $20 or $9？
等级来获取。
Oh, I know that's a $9. It was either one, but it's not that one. Okay.
刚才我们是不是有提到周年庆的邮件奖励？
啊，对。
所以在周年庆的邮件奖励当中，我们也附赠了一部分铸圣之霜。
We also included. Oh, they included the sanctifying for everyone to use. Oh, okay. In the event, I mean, in the anniversary. So in the anniversary mail. Okay.
供大家取用，
周年庆的邮件居然有这么好的东西在吗？
没错，关于铸圣之霜的详细获取规则和消耗规则呢，后续也可以参照游戏内的相关指引。我知道之前一直也有旅行者吐槽啊，觉得我们进行奖励的很多物品我已经用不上了，包括可能我已经溢出的锻造用模矿，包括可能哎我在某个国家的角色呢，他们的天赋等级已经都养满了，
对，
但是你还在持续给我提供这个国家的天赋，是不是感觉很尴尬？
是的。
哎，那么从5.0版本开始呢，我们的进行奖励也会。
Perhaps will be adjusted. Yay!
会进行调整。首先是在进行开始的时候，旅行者们就可以从这四种养成资源中任选其中三种，作为本次进行可获取。
Pick. 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 There's none that says pick up there. Please select the basic battle pass reward.
取得奖励。也就是说，你可以通过自。
So we have options to choose from now. We can pick our thing.
自己的需求来查漏补缺了。此外呢，如果旅行者们解锁了珍珠纪行或者珍珠之歌，并且在达到对应等级之后，我们原本只。
And we can pick our level up materials for our characters' talents. Yes.
定国家的角色天赋培养素材会变成能够让旅行者自由选择任意国家的角色天赋培养素材。
哎，等等，七哥，你现在说的真的是原神吗？
包括你还记不记得我们的旅行者为了去提升
？Wait, do you remember the to increase the stamina limit of the party？
我们队伍的体力上限，他必须得把蒙德和黎月的齐天神像供奉至满级，对不对？你觉得这个问题该不该解决
？Don't you think that's an issue? The issue should be addressed. For our new people who play Genshin.
对啊，不然。
Or anybody who is experiencing one and who has multiple accounts, maybe you're having to do. Mm-hmm. Y'all too.
玩家直接到了纳塔，或者说体验其他的国度，他就体力值就没有办法涨来。
没错，所以既然我们做了主线。
A quick start for new
快速开启，那么一定要把相关的所有的细节都优化到底。嗯，从 5.0 版本更新开。
So starting 5.0,
旅行者们就可以
travels will be able to increase their stamina limit by offering the statue of the seventh in any region.
通过供奉任意区域的七天神像来增加自己的体力值上限了。与此同时呢？
Meanwhile, starting from
从纳塔开始，纳塔的七天神像，纳塔的
the statue of the seven, Nalan,
地灵龛，还有类似像枫丹路径
along with Nalan's, this is the offering system, similar to Fontaine's, out of the
全这样的纳塔独有的供奉系统，也将会提供更
and we also provide more primo rewards
多的原始奖励。哎，我帮大家算了一下啊，上述这些原始奖励。
The total primordial rewards add up to more than intertwined. Oh, 10 of them now. Oh,
加原始奖励，但陆景泉这样的纳塔独有的。
Let's see, y'all get 80 now for that's a was that a precious chest or legendary? I think it was legendary.
也将会提供更多的原始奖励。哎，我帮大家。
I already did the math for you. Yeah, you know the people who do be hardcore, do be doing the math and all the numbers. I'm like, they were gonna do that. They were like, do we actually get all that?
算了一下，上述这些原始奖励加起来的总和有超过十枚纠缠之源的价值哦。
居然又多了十抽。
没错。
哇，我感觉我现在也有点动力要去探索大世界了。嗯。结束了吧。
你希不希望、哎、你希不希望这个福利结束？
不对不对，你这个眼神有点不对。你意思是还有吗？
哎，你看我手卡已经用完了呀。
是啊，
那当然是。
你还给我留了？
我还留有后手。
You got more cards.
给我留了后手。
Michael， 你要知道啊，或者我们的旅行者大家要知道，一般节目的高潮啊都要留到后面的，所以到迄今为止我都还没有收到重量级的信息。
哎，大伟哥来之前完全没有跟我说过。有这些东西啊，
那么这次我也不做，顺序安排，由 Michael 自己去抽一张。
那我先抽这个吧，
先抽这个对不对？你觉得你确定？
确定。
OK， 好。嗯，刚才啊，我们有一位朋友说到过，希望他能够把玩家歪小保底的不好的运气。
Players bad luck with 50/50s to himself, right?
都转到他身上，对吧？ 50/50s. 我们也很佩服。
Oh yeah, 我
这位旅行者的勇气。但是接下来
，But the next about to announce, what is it? What is it?
接下来我
Does it have something to do with the 50/50s?
我要公布的这一项福利，可以些微的分担一下。像这位旅行者的负担。
Oh my, it is true.Burton slightly. What is it,
Michael? 你想不想替各位旅行者先体验一下？
那我就替各位旅行者先验货了啊。
好，那么麻烦我们的工作人员。好，谢谢。
谢谢。
Oh, the primos. Okay. Oh, we can look at her banner. Look at that.
好 ，Michael， 试试看。
嗯。哎，这个特效怎么跟之
前 ？What was that?
好 ，Michael， 试试看。
Wait, what is that? Oh, it turns into a primo. And by a primo, I mean it turns into an intertwined fate.
Hey?
It got a heart. What does the special effect look different from before?
这个特效怎么跟之前的不一样了呀？不会是我欧皇？
Could it be that I got the...
皇附体了吧？
这其实是
This is actually a new event. Event mechanic added to...The character event which is in version 5.0.
我们在 5.0 版本的角色活动起源当中新加入的一个事件叫做捕
Call catching resin
获明光
捕获
catching wait let me see if I'm right catching Capturing radiance.
明光，这个是什么东西？
我给你们解释一下，也就是当晚。
It's when the 50 it's when the 50-50 that that players often mention occurs. There's a chance to incur the wait. It's blah. Let me try to read. There's a chance to encounter the capturing resident.
Capturing radiance.
I keep saying resonance. My brain think about withering waves. Capturing radiance.
玩家啊，常说的小保底到来的时候，有概率会遇到蛊惑。
Will this be helping with our 50-50 problem?
明光事件，当这次是
When the event appears, the result of pulling would be the promoted fire circuit. Wait, what?When this event appears, the result of the pull will definitely be the promoted, the promotional five star character. So when that pops up, we shit out of luck. If that don't pop up, bitch. So that another inkling we don't got the five star. Will this be happening through all the banners or just 5.1?So yeah, y'all, I'll be trying that out when I'm pulling for Miss Melania. We're gonna be seeing that in action. So this adds like another layer of it can be guaranteed in a way, or Well, not guaranteed, but.
事件出现的时候呢，抽取的结果必定为当期的 UP 五星角色，
但是哦。
I'm curious, does this event affects the possibly a previous guarantee?
我比较好奇。
Yeah, I wonder, does it affect? Well, even though, yeah, if you win your 50-50 effects, because you still be on a 50-50.
Yeah, 这个事件会挤占以前的大小保底的概率吗？
哎，知道你就会。
I knew you asked that. Well, obviously, yeah, it's going to ask all the questions.
这么问，我相信旅行者们也非常关心这样一个问题。那么不。
Catching only increases the chance of pulling the current promotional five star. I mean, promotional character when it's a 50-50.
蛊惑明光，它关键就关键在它只是单纯提高了小保底抽中当期 UP 的机会，并不会影响这个游。
It won't affect other possibilities in this
游戏其他所有的概率规则。也就是说，你简单理
解。But yeah, put in simple terms, but it would just increase the chance of pulling the current promotional character. That's all. That's all. It's just gonna increase your chances. So we'll be still on a 50-50 then. If we get the promotional character,
interpret 为我们抽中当期 UP 的概率提高了，就这么简单。
这个消息。还是蛮爆炸的。
更详细的信息
，more details information will be provided in official, visual and open audience in game.
或者后续的官方公告和游戏内的概率公式详情给大家一一说明。
But yeah, but that is major news though. So I'm like, if we see that intertwined fate pop up on a 50-50, we're it gonna be the character? That's amazing. We didn't get sadly we didn't get to see it pop up on the screen.Well, I don't know if they're going to resume showing it, probably. Or just show that new animation of it being the promotional.
那接下来还有吗
？Michael， 你觉得这个消息都不算爆炸性消息是吗？
我觉得已经挺爆炸了。
啊，不过呀，既然你都这么问了，我只能说，确实它是这三个消息中最不爆炸的一个。我们再试试。
Let's now try the weapon, not the weapon banner. Oh my god. Every time I just see weapon banner, I'm like, my soul hurts. It leaves the body.
武器神助复行祈愿。
好，我点出去看。
Looks like the regular weapon banner to me. Remember to set your path.
记得先定轨哦。
哎，不对。
Wait, the number of the fate points seems off.
对吧，这个定轨的数字好像有点问题。
哎，哪个数字有问题啊？
这怎么变成了一？
呀，
你并没有看错，从5.0版本跟
Starting 5.0 which is basically our weapon event
更新开始，
which,
我们的神柱复行起源，也就是武器池，它的定轨上限。
We will be maximizing the amount of fate points, reducing it from 2 to 1. It's something. I'm like, yay. Yay. That's all. I'm like, okay. Hey. So if you lose the weapon that you wanted, you'll get it the next. So basically, like, the getting the character. So basically like that. Is there no like little special thing that with the weapon barrier that it could be like the weapon? But nah, but yeah, as a, it's not too crazy. They just reduce it to 1. But the day will come when they will separate it one day. One day. But I guess reducing it to 1, it's amazing. So you don't have to get up twice the amount of the wishes to get your get the Siggy. So like, okay. So I probably might want to pull on the weapon bear now. Good. Without having to like break a sweat and want to cry.
会从二调整到一，
不会吧？
哎，什么不会吧？
以我对策划的印象，我觉得事情不会那么简单。
啊、
你们肯定会从别的地方把它抠回来的。
啊，你看 Michael 的这个质问就非常的，让我非常的有既视感啊。但是我还是得坦诚的跟大家讲。
I have to be honest with everyone about the
这一次武器的起源定轨，我们真的只是
We really just adjust the number from 2 to 1. we really just adjust the number from, what?
是把它从二下调到了一，仅此而已。我们
That's all there is to it.
没有变。
We haven't changed any of the other original rules.
这种其他所有的原有的规则。我还有
这。One last, even more.
最后一条。
What is that?
更劲爆的消息。还要跟 Michael 和各位旅行、
哎哎哎，七哥，你别吓我，我刚刚开玩笑了，我只是玩家的嘴替，我开个玩笑。
哎，我可没有在开玩笑，对吧？那这次我们确实是真诚的，想给大家再送上一次非常劲爆的福利。
难道说？
没错。那么在今天呢，我在这里去公布我们这一次5.0前瞻节目的最后一条福利投放的消息，也就是从今年开始。
From this year onwards, during every Genshin anniversary, finally took so long to do this. Wait, if I your choice from.This event is limited time. Wait, I can't see. Thing blocking. Turns off. This event is available for limited time during. This event is available for limited time during 5.0. Finally. So, onwards, so every anniversary. So, we will get. We can get a 5-star for free. For free. Let me let them finish. But I'm like, finally. Took so damn long.
每年原神的周年庆版本期间，我们都会。
We will offer all travelers who unlock the wish system a choice to get a free 5-star character from the standard banner. Wonderless. Import. Let me see how to say this. Cause me want to pronounce words tonight.
Wanderlust invocation
for free. So finally, do I have an alert to play for this? I don't think I have an alert. I don't want to use period because I'm just like, by now I know for the people who are new, or this is especially gonna be good for people who be making accounts for specific like things and challenges. Well, obviously it's only gonna be available for 5.0, so you gotta do it within this time period of 5.0. the anniversary. But I know for a majority of people, we already have all these characters. I'm just like, but again, for new people who are coming into the game, or people who are doing challenges, or who making new accounts and all that, I mean, this is amazing, great, love it. But Final fucking Least, I'm saying that because I do have all of them, because me whale be spending, so I eventually was able to get them all. But obviously for people obviously who've been playing the game for a while and all that, who hasn't gotten one of the standard characters yet, this is your time. This is your time to get them while they're hot on the press now for the anniversary. So yeah, but I'm happy though. Finally, they made this a thing. About damn time. I don't know who I'm gonna choose. I gotta see who I want a consolation for.
含的任意一名五星角色的机会。
So
it's not just five-star from the
standard.
But a free selectable five-star character from the standard wish event every year. Well, from every year. So every 1 year, so every anniversary, we'll get a free five-star. And I wonder, will they be adding new five-stars to the standard wishes, which that'll be amazing. Truly. We'll see whoever they add in the future. We don't know, obviously.
选藏住五星吗?
对,你没有听错,
你确定吗? 你在这里说了之后,不能反悔啊, 很多人看到我们这次直播。
我说得很清楚, 是从今年,
不能反悔。
You said, you can't take it back. You can't take it back. A lot of people are watching them. We're going to watch the, our special program. Every year during anniversary event, you will get a chance to choose a five-star character from the standard wish.
活动都会给大家这样一个自选长驻五星的机会。
而且我们的 这个常驻词是一直
we will continue to add. Oh, he asked the question right here. And we will continue to add new characters in our standard wish.
加新角色的.
诶,没错.
That's right. Okay, so they confirmed that. Okay, good. So we will be getting some more characters added to that pool of standard wishes.
我们随着我们版本.
As our previous, more and more characters will be joining the standard wish event.
可能推进啊, 其实会有越来越多的角色加入到奔行时间祈愿当中, 也就是说每年的
annual event will become richer and more options are options as our versions progress.
这个福利也会随着版本的推进, 它的选项会逐渐丰富起来。 怎么样? 你觉得这个福利？基哥，我说实话。Okay.
This isn't all these updates and all the new things. I'm like, okay, this is really juicy, really juicy. Especially with the 50-50 thing. I'm like, oh, okay. They are a lot. They really going. They are act out. Really trying to act out.
我鸡皮疙瘩都起来了，我今天这个。 我真的有点懵啊，就是，哇，我没想到今天的福利居然是这样的。我感觉你的心情还没有从刚才的这些消息中缓过来。我有点这些消息中缓过来。对，我确实有点没缓过来。
那我们给 Michael 一点冷静的时间啊，那我也想代表团队呢，跟大家去说几句。我们虽然是。 原神这个游戏的开发者，但同时我们也是原神的玩家，这一点一直从 1.0 开始，我都在不断的跟大家传达这样一个信息。那么玩家提出的一切的问题，我们作为玩家当然也都是感同身受的。
是的。
因为原神接下来要走的路也很困难也很长，但是我希望它能够一直延伸下去。我们能够一直走下去也离不开大家一直以来的持续关注和支持。
没错，
那么接下来就到了 Michael 的回合了。
虽然我觉得我们所准备的内容不如刚刚的惊喜，但是我们准备的周年庆相关内容呢比往年还是只多不少。我们想带给大家的其实很简单，旅行者们能够收获一些简单的快乐，我们就非常满足了。
我们平时也非常重视每位旅行者的声音，我觉得项目组的大家其实都是发自内心的去认可还是要以高品质的核心内容创作作为它最重要的基石。我们要持续不断地去做出好内容本身，这才是我们一直能够走下去的立身之本。那如果说我们做的内容没有让玩家没有让旅行者感受到乐趣，那一定是我们哪里出现了问题。我们会非常非常乐意去收集大家的看法进行调整。
七哥突然之间感慨起来了呢。
那么接下来啊，还是再看一些有意思的短片来转换一下气氛吧。
What's this? Oh? And this is so, oh wow.Colors. That was so mesmerizing. There was no words for me to say. This is so, oh, the Archons. My heart, my chest.The Archons. Well, the ones we have so far. Well, we just need one more. We're just missing one. We have all of them. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We're just missing the 7th. Are we missing... What's her name? What is her name? It's a Sarissa. What's her name? The Cairo Archon. Damn it. Is it Sarissa? I feel like that's somebody else's like name. But yeah, we're just missing Pyro Archon. But all the Archons are here. This is so cute. I love it. And my fave, Nahita. My heart. Wait, let me add the last code. Because y'all, we're getting to the end, hopefully. It's gonna be a long reaction video.
在之前的版本中呀，我们放出了一个常驻玩法幻想真境巨狮。那么在这几个版本期间呢，我们也收到了大量的玩家反馈，我们非常关注玩家对这些内容的建议，并且啊，有很多玩家的建议其实给了我们迭代的灵感。所以我们从4.8开始就一直在对这个玩法进行调整。那在接下来即将更新的5.0版本当中呢，我们全量重新设计了玩法当中的奇妙。
I have not touched the imagine the data yet. I'm not dead yet.
注意事件，那 在新的版本当中呢，这些事件将根据当期的三元素所对应的反应体系进行有效清晰的策略引导。简单来讲，就是你拿到这个注意的时候就已经知道它应该给什么样的队伍使用了。
老实说，之前这些 buff 我都看得不是很明白。
没错没错，这也是很真实的一个玩家反应。
是的，
那这些注意事件呢也将提供非常强大的特殊元素反应机制，也就是他们是贴合原有的反应体系去制作的。即使玩家对自己手头能够出战的角色机制不够了解，他也能够简单的通过元素搭配来展开有效的进攻策略。这本来也是我们去设置每一期元素主题的初衷。嗯，那当然了，可能会有玩家会问啊，那如果你们设置了这么强大的体系增益之后，会不会导致这些玩法越发的没有挑战性？所以在 5.0 版本呢，我们对于追求更高难度的挑战者也会开启新的卓越模式，卓越模式当中所对应的奖励内容也会增加，所以也希望玩家能够持续的对我们后续推出的玩法不断的提出建议，我们会及时的收集并设法不断的完善这些游戏的体验。
没错，
此外呢，在 5.0 版本我们还会有一些老朋友加入我们的七圣召唤卡牌当中，那新的角色卡、新的怪物卡以及行动牌也会等待大家收集，还会有新的纳塔牌背等待大家获取哦。
另外还有联动活动要跟大家分享，纸符双印原定在预，原神与罗技的首次联动即将到来哦。
罗技吗？
哦、oh, ，they collaborated with Logitech。
没错，定制款罗技产品将在九月的罗技 Play。
Okay, Ayaka, love your room girl。
发布会上与大家正式见面，罗技的社媒平台啊也即将公布联名产品信息。此外，还有多种联名周边可以获取。各位旅行者喜欢的话千万不要错过。哇，
罗技的定制款，哎，你要知道我从小到大用的都是罗技的外设。
哇，
这可太酷了。嗯， Michael， 听说你今天应该还给大家带来了一些音乐方面的消息。
是的，纳塔音乐也必须在这个环节给大家分享。据我所知啊，纳塔的音乐风格跟枫丹相比起来是要特殊的非常多的。接下来就请旅行者们拿起手边的花生瓜子饮料矿泉水入席就坐，纳塔交响音乐会马上开始。
Now you can hear the music from I'm Not Land. And I think this is what mostly gonna take up the rest of this probably. Oh yeah, no, them still gonna be talking. And we still got some more like stuff. Okay. Not to be a 7-hour screen. Shambulia bebasila Pikanam pakam we show Quantie tutu tau Uzatamu yo yo te Rudi qua pamba chaya Nya Hadithia endelea Peshima warithi visa Leading this with up with song. Mm-hmm. Another one, but that was amazing. That phenomenal. I was just amazed sitting here, just like so good. They are so pretty. Oh my God. Yo, that was amazing. I couldn't, there was no words. I was saying some things in the second song, but the first one, it was, we just, I just had to shut up and just listen. It was amazing. It was amazing. It was amazing. Oh. They know how to fuck up a good soundtrack for the game. That's all I can say. They know how to mess it up, especially for Sumeru and Natlan, because y'all know I love, obviously, Sumeru is my favorite region, but also too, I love Sumeru's music. Oh, but Natlan's too. Natlan, both of them are like my faves with the music. I'm like, I love it. Ooh. But yeah, but music, amazing. And so much melanin we've seen in melanation we've seen in the music was playing. Just gorgeous, beautiful people. Not to all, obviously, the other people as well, but I mean, the queens and kings, just ooh, loved. But yeah. But we got a little bit more left to go.
今天大家表现都很好嘛，看来我这个老演员是不是可以退休了？
表现是我自我还是不是那么满意啊，而且压力也是相当的大。不过我觉得如果旅行者们能喜欢我们这次纳塔的内容的话，我觉得效果就已经到位了。
那今天介绍完这个今天的内容啊，我这里还有最后一个问题啊，也是之前问卷中有玩家提到的，就是项目组啊内部对于原神未来有什么样的规划，有没有什么可以提前透露的一些有趣内容啊？
我先说规划的问题吧。在此之前我想提个题外话，就是在到期版本上线的那一年，我记得有一个海外媒体的朋友有问我一个问题，说这一年的开发感受如果用一个词来概括的话，你觉得什么样的词最合适？那当时我其实用了一个词叫进化。这个词不光是指我们整个团队为了去做更多原先从未体验过的内容所做出的个人努力，所做出的团队的进化，另一方面其实也是直到今天大家看到的像纳塔这样的内容，也是我们这个进化之路上的其中一小步。那每年我们都会努力的做出一些让大家眼前一亮的有新概念的内容呈现给大家。那刚才大家也问在故事上我们有没有什么长线规划，我们会在未来的旅途上遇到更多的伙伴和敌人，那么他们其中有一些呢一直活在坊间传闻当中，那还有一些呢可能迄今为止和玩家只有一面之缘，玩家和他们也不甚了解，那还有一些呢可能他们对旅行者是陌生的，对于提瓦特的众人也是陌生的，但是这些人和世界的命运之间也是息息相关的。那旅行者前往寻找自己血亲的这个旅途，实际上也会和这个世界之间的联系因为上述的原因越来越紧密。
那么基哥也给我们介绍了很多原神未来的规划，那么也是让我们对未来啊充满着期待。我们今天的那个前瞻特别节目啊到这里呢也就接近尾声了。那原神到现在啊都已经4年了，我也有很多心里话啊想跟我们旅行者讲。我们一起从2020年的那个秋天启程呢，已经是相伴的走过了4个年头，那共同度过了许多难忘的时刻。那随着这个探索的步伐不断前行啊，那提瓦特的这个大陆也是愈加的这个丰富多彩。那我也相信未来的每一片新的地域啊，每一段新的故事啊，会成为我们最美好的这个回忆啊。那过去的这一年啊，原神项目组和我啊，都是曾经经历了这个焦虑和迷茫的。我们听到了很多的声音啊，有的把原神吹上天，有的把原神啊贬的。
Wait, excuse me. Hold up,
秋天，难忘的时刻。那随着这个探索的
，as we continue to explore,
步伐不断前行啊。那提瓦特
，the world, it's about becoming ever more rich and colorful.
那这个大陆也是愈加的这个丰富多彩。那我也相信未来的
，I believe every,
每一片新的地域啊，每一段新的故事。
I was like, wait, huh?
是啊，会成为我们最美好的这个回忆啊。那过去的这一年啊，原神项目组和我啊，都是曾经经历了这个焦虑和迷茫的。我们听到了很多的声音啊，有的把原
Some praise and attention about to oh I read that wrong. Never mind.
飞上天，有的把原神啊贬得一无是处啊。这样的声音多了啊，难免让项目组和我都有点不知所措。我自己回想起原神这一路走来啊， 其实旅行者的热情、期望与反馈啊，让我们有了不断前行的这个动力啊，也是元神啊能够不断进步的这个源泉。于是啊，今年上半年啊，元神项目组和我啊决定去跟世界各地的旅行者面对面聊聊。我们去了很多我们从来没有去过的城市，比如湖北襄阳啊，比如巴西圣保罗啊。在跟全球各地的旅行者面对面的时候啊，每一位旅行者都非常激动地跟我们分享他们的提瓦特旅程啊。他们有的还在每天体验原神，有的呢只是新版本更新上来体验一下，有的呢已经很久没有来过提瓦特。跟他们聊完呢，制作组和我重新理解了旅行的意义啊。我们的脑子里啊想起了那句啊，我们终将重逢啊。我们意识到啊，只有对旅行者的陪伴是原神唯一不能改变的，其他一切皆可改变。也正是因为有了各位旅行者啊，我们才有机会在未来带来更多精彩优质的内容。最后呢，我们将在八月
Finally we will be welcoming the new version 5.0 August 28th. So yeah, y'all get your calendars. That's on a Wednesday, y'all already know I'm booked and busy the following Wednesday with the new update, so can I wait to get into it? Oh, also too, I know people who play on mobile. Ciao. Y'all phones are going to explode. Your phones are going to go poop. Depending on how much storage you got, but I know this update going to be huge. It's going to be huge.
月二十八日迎来全新的 5.0 版本火之国纳塔，那这片炙热而神秘的土地啊，也是等待着每一位勇敢的旅行者前去探索。感谢大家一直以来的支持与陪伴，愿你们的纳塔之旅充满惊喜与期待。旅行者们，我们纳塔见，
拜。
我感觉他们很放松，比我们之前这个，我在场的时候要轻松很多。
鸡哥怎么回事？都不提前跟我商量一下？还有不是跟我说是综艺效果吗？怎么整的是我啊？
啊！我不知道，龙龙不知道，我只是一条孽龙，你不要来找我，是大尾龙要我干的，要找大尾龙去啊！
我不在的时候他们谈笑风生。
哟，好玩吗？
好玩，咋了？
像不像 bug 单？
像你的 bug 单。拿这么的，
我就看你还修不修你 bug。
修完了，
走走走，赶紧回去修 bug 去。
看你修 bug。
Hello, travelers, and welcome to Tevat Talks. I'm Zach Aguilar, voice of Ether, co-hosting with my friend and voice of Albedo, Koi Dao.
Huh? Friend, huh?
The best friends.
Like that one time you played Wind Trace without me.
Hey, everyone! Genshin Impact invited us to be part of the 4th anniversary celebration this year. 4 years. That's crazy. Wow, I can't believe it's been so long. These past 4 years, I've had the pleasure of delivering some epic grunt sounds as Aether, voicing emotional dialogue in the Archon quests, and working on the special programs. So many great memories have been made not only working on the game, but also playing it. What do you think, Koi?
Oh my gosh, 4 years. Wow. You know, I turned 4 years old once. It was awesome. Back then, I never thought I'd get to voice such a cool and intelligent character in an exciting game like Genshin Impact. We know that many of our fellow castmates have had some fun, sometimes truly unbelievable experiences over the past 4 years. So let's bring in a few special guests to, as Albedo might say, turn the unknown into the known.
Let's do it.
Let's go.
Happy 4 year anniversary, everyone! I'm Kimberly Ann Campbell, the voice of Nahida. And I know what you're thinking. A lot of people are like, wow, you sound so different from Nahida.
That voice range just be eaten, truly.
time during a rare live stream for me, someone in the chat told me to prove that I was actually the voice of Nahida. So both on
you can kind of hear it in their undertones a little bit of their voice. You can like hear it like under, like you gotta legit listen really hard to their voice, and like you can like hear I can hear my Dendro Archon in there.
Online and in person at conventions, I get a handful of people who seem to be very surprised that that voice comes out of my body. What can I say? It's just what I sound like. I usually whip out a "everyone hold hands" to prove I'm not lying.
Yeah, that's super relatable. Like, I usually just scream Windblade at people to prove that it's me. Or make a "huh" sound.
Or even just in your private moments.
Yeah.
I've heard you scream it.
Exactly. I turn to my right side and I scream, "Windblade!" It helps scare away the demons.
That's weird. You're a weird guy.
Anyways, here's more guests.
I'm so lucky that I get to see a lot of Genshin Impact fans and cosplayers, especially the Raiden Shogun cosplayers, at conventions all over the world. And it's so cute when fans come up to my table and realize that I don't usually sound like her. So someone will come up and say, "Oh, are you the voice of Raiden Shogun? Oh yeah, that's me. Can you do a line?" And I'll be like, "Inazuma shines eternal." And watching their eyes light up always makes me smile. Genshin Impact fans are so passionate, and I love you guys.
Oh.
I personally have a lot to celebrate. When Genshin Impact dropped, almost immediately, my life began to change in a measurable way. I began to meet more and more people, online, at conventions, and honestly, in my daily life, who are so passionate about this game. And I've learned that I love to sneak up on Genshin Impact cosplayers, and then when I'm right behind them, say something like, "This is an age of gods and monsters. I wish not for dominion, yet I cannot watch the common folk suffer." I mean, the reactions are genuinely priceless. And I frequently hear from people online that that was one of the highlights of their con. I meet people that are so excited about this game that they literally tear up. I mean, honestly, how lucky am I to be a part of something like that?
Aw, that's so sweet.
Wow. My heart.
And that is such a funny thing to do at conventions. Can you imagine sneaking up on people and suddenly speaking in voice? Except I just get really shy.
Yeah.
Who else we got?
Okay, first... Me just losing my mind every time. I'm just like, My Hydro baby, my Hydro dragon baby. But he eats up the Hydro men very well, because he also voiced Ayato as well. And I'm just like, what's up with him and Hydro? I ain't complaining about it. But he just eats up the Hydro men very well.
First off, I want to give a big thank you to the team at Genshin Impact for letting me play the most beautiful man I have ever seen.
He is, and I love him, and he's so sweet. Yes. Just with Nahida, he has my heart as well. They're right next to each other in here.
Seriously, Nouvellet is a prized character of mine, one I'm just so excited to play and dig into for years to come. While he does have a range of subtle emotional beats and some true cathartic twists, nothing about him can possibly compare to the elephant seal in the room. The month of Oratrice Mechanique d'Analyse Cardinal changed my life forever. Who could possibly have seen that coming?
Literally, how many memes that came out from that? I'm just like, wow.
Genshin Impact fans are so polite whenever I meet them. They never ask me to say it, but of course I always do. And their gratitude about, "He said the thing," is always...
Yeah, that would be... I don't go to conventions like that or anything. But obviously, hearing like, knowing of somebody who do, and seeing them out in the wild somehow, voice a character in game, I would not ask them to say nothing from that, because they probably wouldn't want to. But obviously, they're saying that they would, obviously. But I'm just like, I wouldn't want to ask.
always a palpable delight. All right, let's do it. Oratrice mécanique d'analyse cardinale. Thank you.
Get out of my ears with that. Get out of my ears with that.
Thank you.
He said the thing! He said the thing!
He did say the thing. You say the thing.
Oratrice mécanique d'analyse cardinale.
Oratrice mécanique d'analyse cardinale.
Yippee!
Yippee! So who's the most beautiful man you've ever seen, Zach? There's a correct answer.
When I looked into your eyes, Coy.
Mm-hmm. Go on.
I knew that the most beautiful man I ever saw was the reflection in your eyes, me!
I knew it. I knew it. I knew that's where it was going.
Hair flip.
Well, that was fun.
Yeah. Thanks for coming, everybody. And what an awesome 4 years of Genshin Impact.
So much happened.
Yeah.
We've got some surprises in store, so stay tuned for other Teyvat Talks.
Teyvat Talks, Talks.
Stay tuned, talks. All right?
Out to the girlies.
Welcome to Teyvat Talks. I'm Sarah Miller-Cruz, the English voice of Lumine, and joining me are my lovely co-hosts, Crystal and Jenny.
Yay!
Hey,
hi, everybody.
Goyles.
Crystal Lee here. I voice Clarand, the legendary champion duelist herself. Pew, pew, pew.
Hello. It is me. I have returned. It is Jenny Okobori. I am the voice of Yoimiya. And I hope this anniversary sparks joy with all of you out there.
I see what you did there.
Speaking of the anniversary, how are you two celebrating this amazing milestone?
Oh, one heck of a milestone. 4 years? That's like enough to get a bachelor's degree. I mean, I'm going to celebrate my graduation from Genshin Impact University. That's what I'm doing. Yes. I don't know about you guys. What about you, Sarah?
That's amazing. I haven't planned anything specific yet, but I'm sure I'll play more Genshin Impact as usual.
Come on, you've been in this game since
you
the beginning.
You win, Sarah.
Nothing?
No, listen. I've been looking for him for 4 long years.
For 4 years, looking for this twin show.
Okay.
Crystal, you mentioned that you're going to graduate. I think I'm going to enroll in grad school so I can stay here for as long as I can.
Yes.
I'm enjoying
sure.
my time.
Because that's the best move. Get that PhD. Yes. Also, get that postdoc.
I am very much a person that is motivated by sweet little treat culture, and so I just want to know when my next sweet little treat's going to be, and I think I want to indulge in a cake. I want to get one of the Genshin Impact birthday cakes that they send you on your birthday. It's 4 years of looking at them, and I want one.
Oh my god, about time.
Anyway, let's go ahead and turn to our guests and see what they have to say about this momentous occasion.
Yay!
Who we got?
Happy anniversary, Genshin Impact! I'm so humbled to be part of such a vast world and talented cast. When I auditioned for Chiori, I felt such a connection to her inner strength as a fellow AFAB business owner, who is often told they are intimidating, who was discouraged at the beginning of their career, and who has big aspirations. Throughout the recording, Chiori has continued to inspire me through her bold and individualistic style, and I hope to have brought a bit of me to you all through her.
Love her. Love Chiori. Pretty, she ate eating up Chiori.
Oh, that is so sweet.
Wait, that's lovely.
I love that. I love Brittany.
That is so great.
That's an amazing answer. I really love how, like, Genshin Impact shows a lot of really strong women, you know? Like, a business owner as, like, being one of such example. That's amazing.
Yes. Oh my gosh. And I feel like a lot of us do feel such connections to our characters, and that's partially what I think, you know, like helps us
really connect,
bring them to life. You know what I mean? I feel like I'm a lot like Lumine because I also have a twin brother in real life.
Yes.
So it's one of the reasons that recording for the We Are Reunited quest is like so special and emotional for me. Honestly, I've gotten teary-eyed basically every single time we've recorded Aether and Lumine getting to be together again, because I really cannot imagine how horrible it would be to be separated from my twin brother. It just like makes me so emotional.
Sarah.
It's one of the reasons that when our amazing director was giving me direction for the opening cutscene where they get separated, it actually made me cry. The end.
I love to laugh.
Farina.
If you can tell. And I love to laugh as Farina, especially. Some of my favorite Booth moments involve doing her variety of laughs. I also kept cracking up later on when she's directing and shouts, "Action!" I had so much fun doing those in a variety of ways, and I'm so, so happy the team liked the variety and even some of the sillier ones. You know the ones. On the other side of the spectrum, one of my favorite scenes I got to do was when Farina was on stage, reliving all those different moments from her past up to the current day. I'm not joking when I say I couldn't stop crying in the booth while recording those.
Child, the Fontaine Archon Quest, ooh, it had us all bent and just, ooh, going through it with her. I'm just like, Farina.
Legit. Tears for days.
Oh. That's a lot of tears today. That's a lot of,
my gosh. Literally. I know. I guess everyone's talking about things that made them emotional.
Right. Yes,
my eyes are getting watery. I need to stop.
Gosh.
I'm just like, I'm going to keep saying this because just because I love so much of our cast, but I'm like, I love Amber. And
yes, she's also, amazing.
Like, it's very true. Like, she does love to laugh. She's a close friend of mine, and I can confirm that. So I feel like Farina was just made for her.
Right. And it's like the way that a lot of people match up with their characters and relate so well, it's one of the most incredible things. And like, seriously, Farina has some of the cutest laughs
yes.
ever.
Absolutely agree.
Yeah. Oh my gosh. Well, okay. I mean, back to the question though. What about you, Jenny?
Okay, so I mean, my first job when I moved out to LA was actually being a pyrotechnician.
Wait, no way.
Are you serious? That's amazing.
What?
You know what I mean? It was legit made for her.
I had such a blast, pun fully intended, by the way, at that job, and it really helped shape who I am. And I honestly feel like Yoimi and I were kind of meant for each other.
Mm-hmm.
It definitely feels like fate. Our similarities even like go beyond working with fireworks too. Yoimi and I are extremely bubbly and very talkative, as you guys have probably picked up on by now.
Yep.
I love you both for it.
Thank you. However, I think the most meaningful similarity is the love we both feel for our disabled fathers. My father has since passed, but I grew up as the primary caretaker for my father who had Alzheimer's. So seeing Yoimi interact and help her father really struck a chord with me.
Yeah.
I'm getting a little bit choked up. I love her so much. Yoimi honestly means more to me than I could ever properly articulate. I've met so many friends, like present company included, because of this opportunity that I've gotten to voice her, including her Japanese voice actor, who I got to meet last year, and she was so, so lovely.
Oh, amazing.
Oh, my gosh.
And I've also just seen so much of the world through conventions.
Yeah.
It's such an unbelievable honor to lend my voice to Yoimiya, who's just, like, who's a character that just brings joy to so many people all over the world.
You do such a beautiful job of
yes.
it, too.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you.
Even though I don't have Yoimiya yet, but she keep coming at the wrong times on the wrong banners. I'm like, I need to back her. I need to back her. I need to back her.
When I was cast as Venti, I was like, yay, I'm so excited to be a bard because I love singing. Yay. So for the Vinlesa Fest, Venti keeps talking about how he's rehearsing this big song and that he's going to perform it at the end of the event. And he keeps saying the word song. So when we got to that final performance, I was like, hey, just for funsies, since we're running ahead of schedule, can I do a version where I sing at the end just for fun? And the team was like, sure, if you can come up with a tune really quick, we can do it just for fun. So I went on break for like 5 minutes and came back with a little tune for the lyrics and then,
And 5 minutes, ooh, me would have been still scratching my head with them 5 minutes. I'm like,
recorded it in one take. It was super fun. But I didn't expect them to actually use it in the game because, like I've said 5,000 times, it was just for fun. And so when the event came out and people started excitingly tagging me in posts about Venti singing, I was so shocked and so excited. Oh my gosh. And it was just so sweet to see how much Venti singing meant to the fans. Like, the reactions were so heartwarming. And I was so happy. I'd love to sing in the game for another event sometime, you know, but I'm also happy to go back to his pretty poetry too. I'm just really happy that I got to sing at least once in the game.
Oh,
wait, yes.
What? That's
That's incredible. Gosh. She just came up with the tune, like,
yes,
spontaneously, just there.
Right on the spot.
That's
I love it.
That's Erica for you. I mean,
I know,
like, listen.
I know. Girl, and, like, I don't know if y'all have heard the Venti song from that event, but it is so good. Erica did such an amazing job.
That's incredible. One
she's
take.
She's
so 5 minutes.
Talented. She really is.
She's so talented.
That's crazy.
I know.
Oh my
well,
gosh.
Okay, so we've been hearing about how all these people feel like a connection to their character, and I was wondering, Crystal, if you have an answer to that.
Oh my gosh.
Clarion.
Juicy.
I mean, yeah, no. I think one of the things that really brought me so close to Clarion was when I found out she was a secret nerd. Like,
yes.
The second I found out she plays tabletop and like plays tabletop with her friends, like Navia, and I was like, that's crazy, because I walked in and everyone on the call was like, hey, so I don't know if you know about tabletop or like, you know, certain games involving tabletop. And I was like, are you kidding me? I live for that stuff. I love it so much. And so to be able to bring that side to her was just so incredibly fun. And I loved connecting with how much she... like, she's secretly super, super friendly. Like, you don't expect it when you meet her. She's, like, super stoic and, like, down to business. But secretly, she's just out here loving her friends and, like, supporting people. And, I don't know.
We just love that. Because, obviously, the character is in Fontaine. Like, Newbie, you, as I said, when I don't know if I said it when we first got introduced to him in the game. Because he comes off, and I think in the Fontaine teaser for the characters, he looked like he would not give you the time of day or just have a stick up his bum. But we obviously got to meet him in the game. He's just so sweet and just so kind. I'm just like, I love him. And he's just so old gentleman. And I love it. And then, of course, Clarion, when we got to know her a little bit more, obviously with her story quest. And also too, throughout the main arc on Quest and Fontaine, she is sweet. Obviously, when she's in business, she means business. Just like with Newbie, business. They don't play. But when they're on their downtime and all that, they're just so, like, it's just a whole different, like, not side, but they're very chill and very, like, nice, and they're just so cute, and I love it. So, yeah.
I love that aspect of her. She just felt, she really came alive when I found that much more about her personal life beyond her role in the court. It was so much fun. And
that's so cute. I love
her
that.
So much. Thank you.
Oh my gosh. Well, it's been so great to hear from all these different actors. I've loved this. This is great.
Amazing.
This is really fun. I know. I love hearing about how everyone connected, like, personally. It's like that little backstage glimpse that you don't usually get.
Yes.
A little peek behind the curtain, if you will.
Exactly. And I still can't believe it's been 4 years. I feel like no time at all has passed somehow. Like, and also all the time has passed.
Like, time, it's so surreal. It really
is. Who knows?
Well,
oh my
gosh. I mean,
well, this has been great. I've had so much fun with y'all today.
Same. And I can't wait for the next. So, I mean, hey, everyone, stay tuned for more. And happy anniversary, travelers.
Yes. Happy anniversary!
Woo!
Oh. It's got a little bit more.
Hello,
left.
Everybody. This is Alejandro Saab, voice of Sino, and thanks for tuning in to Tevet Talks.
Hey, everyone. Joe Zija, voice of Risley here, wishing everybody a happy Genshin Impact 4-year anniversary.
Yeah, same. Dude, I can't believe it's been 4 years. Oh my gosh. I remember when the game first started and I was like, I have no idea what I'm doing. And now I'm like, I know a little bit of what I'm doing.
Yeah, I don't think I've even reached a little bit. I think, like, when I stream the game, it's mostly entertaining because I don't know what I'm doing at all. It's been awesome to get to know the fan base and the game, and it's just this Genshin Impact has become this whole massive world. Like, who could have imagined?
Yeah, it's crazy. Yeah, so I totally get it. So, without further delay, let's check out what our voice actors have to say about this landmark occasion in our journey.
Hi, I'm Erin Avett, the English voice of the Knave, a.k.a. Arlecchino. Oh, a.k.a. Father. We've recorded many Arlecchino scenes over the years that I am really quite fond of, but I think the ones that I recall most warmly are those that explored her moments of vulnerability and chilly tenderness.
Yeah, I love those parts about her.
Particularly in those few intimate
with
moments
children.
With her children or with Clairvy.
I knew we made something special while in the booth, but oh boy. Watching the finished sequences with all the other actors' performances in there instantly made me so proud to be a part of this cast. And yes, it's also quite fun to play her viciously cool and aloof yet badass sides too. So thank you all for letting me be a small piece of this huge narrative adventure, and for being such an incredible and welcoming community. Congrats on 4 amazing years, Genshin. Here's to many more.
Man, Arlecchino is so cool, and I absolutely adored that story. It was dark, and it was just sad at times. But you know, a lot of work goes into building the voices for these characters, you know?
Yeah, and sometimes like you don't know what the work's going to be until you get there. One of my favorite lines of Risley's is, if the Duke wants somebody dead, he needs no justification. And a lot of people don't know that it's one of the first scenes we ever did in the booth. And I remember thinking like, whoa, this guy's like rough. He's a prison warden. He's over here saying he's above the law. Okay, I guess, you know, we'll play him tough, right? We'll play him really rough. And then it turned out that he was this really intelligent, respectable, even like kind man. Yeah. And so I just had to take that toughness that was, you know, kind of right out the gate and then apply it to his otherwise really formal language. He speaks really intelligently.
Yes. Again, more with the appearances. What did I say? The appearances can look deceiving. Yeah. All that. But, you know, he really calm, really big brain energy, Risley. And loves his tea.
But he's also got this kind of like blue collar spirit that makes for a super interesting mix. It was just one of those fun experiments in character development on the fly.
Yeah, yeah. Moments like that are absolutely awesome, especially when portraying these characters that have so many layers and so many dimensions. I mean, in Sino's second story, we got to see so many layers of Sino, you know. We're so used to him being nice to his friends after so many patches in Genshin Impact, you know. Like, he's like, oh, let's play Genius Invocation TCG. Here's a random joke. But it's cool that we finally got to, you know, a nice reminder that he's still the general Mahamantra.
Yeah, and it, like, all of us have our own little stories about how we came to it, and they're all really unique. So let's see how some others spent their time behind the mic for this.
Yeah.
First of all, congratulations on 4 years, you cute people. I mean, wow, I have been part of the incredible Genshin Impact universe for almost exactly a year now. And let me just say, I was instantly hooked. From the talented team at miHoYo and our voice directors to the hardworking studio crew and the players around the globe, there is such an incredible energy tying us all together. When we started our records and I dove into Navia's emotional roller coaster of a backstory, I knew that this game was something special. I mean, Malus and Silver still make me tear up just.
Why you had to bring it up every time, man? You had to bring up Malus and Silver. If y'all haven't played the again Fontaine Archon quest, you will find out what happens to them. We still. It's been a year. It's been almost been a year. We, as you just said, we still be tearing up. I'm just like, oh my god.
Just thinking about them.
Oh man, Silver and Malus. I miss those guys. They were so cool. They were funny, but man, good times.
Yeah, I can't wait to meet him. I haven't gotten to that part of the game yet, so before we get any spoilers, let's hear from Amber and Stephanie.
Yeah.
We can't spoil it for him.
Congratulations on the 4-year anniversary.
Emily.
This year has been the most exciting for me because
Amber.
I get to be a part of a game that transcends not only story and beauty, but also a great community of players. Emily was such a fun character to play. She's calm during stressful or terrifying situations, yet gentle when it's called for. She can read the room and sniff problems out pretty quickly, too.
Get it? Because she perfumes, fragrances, sniff.
I knew she had to be mature enough to have the smarts and kind enough to care for others. Her character impressed me every day in the studio. When I found out which character I was to play and her impact in the game, I was on a break in studio and the engineer told me Emily was the main character for this update. Initially, I didn't understand, but then once we recorded more and more, it hit me. I am now part of the Genshin Impact family, which is pretty awesome! It is a true honor. Thank you for having me.
I still can't believe I've been in the game for nearly 4 years. It's wild to think that I started as Cloud Retainer the NPC.
Mm-hmm. To Cloud Retainer, the legit in-game character we can play. Which I need to still learn her name. Pronounce her name, child. Ooh.
But I am so proud of getting to play her.
Yeah, hello. Mommy Cloud Retainer. She's just so fun to play with the plunging and everything.
Not only is she a character that has helped me stretch my own vocal range, but she's also so full of life and mystery and so unintentionally hilarious. Mm-hmm. I started playing her as the mysterious and not so kind Adeptus, as we all know. And every time I would return for events, I'd get to give insight into other beloved characters through some pretty funny quips or some deeply sad backstories. So when I was asked to give her life as the playable Shen Yun, one was over the moon. I mean, with her human form, I would be able to share her softer side, the side that we've only had glimpses of. So one was really loving getting to play the funny, soft, strong, intelligent, sassy, and loving character that she is. I mean, she is the type of character that has made Genshin Impact so special for so many people throughout the years. So thank you so much for asking me to be her. And happy 4-year anniversary, Genshin Impact.
Aw. That, man, I'm a nerd for this game. I love Genshin Impact.
I feel like we're all nerds for this game, Cho.
And just hearing so many people and all of the actors in this cast just be so excited about it. I'm not gonna lie, it made me tear up a little. And I know that folks are gonna be like, no, you didn't. And I'm like, man, It just makes my heart warm.
Let the man cry. Like, yeah. Come on, let him feel a little bit. One of the things, like, the through line here for me is how we have this thing called Genshin Impact, or any story, really. And all we're hearing from actors is that how it evolved, right? Like, no one knows what shape it's going to take. You just release this thing into the world, and then the collaborative efforts of all these people kind of morph and change, and it's developed so organically. It's really, really cool, like a living, breathing organism, but it's just art.
Yeah, and I'm just so honored that I get to be a part of this, of the English cast. Same. With you and everybody else.
Yeah.
Well, everyone, that's a wrap on Teyvat Talks. Thanks for tuning in.
These 4 years of Genshin Impact have been amazing, and the adventure continues on.
And y'all, that is it for the special program. Ciao, y'all. It's a lot. It was so much information. So many things, the characters, new characters, wishes, and just so much. I obviously can't reiterate everything, but the stream itself, me talking throughout the whole thing, will get y'all up. But it's a lot of updates to things that needed updating and all that. Just so many things that I can't obviously recap as at this moment and now. But again, I hope y'all enjoyed. This was 2 hours and 14 minutes. This is the longest reaction to a, I think, however, stream I did. But if I'm thinking correctly, 2 hours. And it's going to be all a video. I was debating on at the end, like, because it was just actors talking. But I was like, obviously, I want to hear the actors and them talking and now everything, which good thing I did, because it was amazing. Hearing how they connected so deeply with the character and all that, and translated to their real life, and I just loved that. It's fun getting to know the actors behind the characters that we love in the games. I'm just like, that was amazing. It's a good thing I stayed and watched. But yeah. Ooh, but now I'm gonna end the video. But yeah, so as I said, on the 28th, which is a Wednesday, yes. Obviously, I will be back when I'll be streaming me playing the new of the Archon Quest and going into Natland and all that. And if you want to see me playing that live and all, you already know I stream on the Twitchy and on the Tube. For people who don't want to go to Twitch and watch me play it, I multi-stream anyway, so you can watch me on the Tube play it as well if you don't have Twitchy. All my stuff is in the description for y'all below. Socials, my streaming schedule, all that. It says on Wednesday I don't stream, but I make an exception for the new update, obviously, of Horror Versus Game, so I'll be live Wednesday on the 28th. See ya. And also, too, I put all my other stuff that I set up, I'm gonna put up in the thing that be popping up. Let me re-say that. Until the next reaction to another Horror Versus games or another game that is not Horror Versus. Until the next one. Bye, y'all. If y'all stay through this whole reaction, I'm surprised. Because this obviously could be a thing y'all put on in the background while you're doing something. Obviously. But if you stuck around to this to the end, appreciate you. But yeah, until the next time. Bye, y'all.